This is the debut season, and a short while back we had the Honorable Governor, we had the legend of legends, Kapil Dev as well, and obviously he needs no introduction. The World Cup winning captain, the first one for India, the biggest all-rounder the world has ever seen. And then the formalities were held as well. Ribbon cutting is such a good thing to see and a good thing to have. Honorable Governor Fagu Chauhanji was there. Deputy Chief Minister of Bihar Tarkishore Prasadji was there. And amidst a big, loud rapture, noise, applause, you say it. And we had a great amount of energy and a great buzz around the stadium. People will be coming in, as but we are maintaining social distancing too. Temperature, pretty okay, 33. Wind is fairly okay, so no forecast for the rain. And when I talk about this, a short while... Oh, Ravi is right here with me. Ravi Kant Singh, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Pradham, and what a nice bright sunshine and a perfect weather as we go over and see what Pradham did with the toss.
The much awaited moment is right here. We are talking about the Bihar Cricket League, BCL. Finally, 20th of March has arrived. The two captains are here. The match referee, Ravi Shankar, is here. Toss representative, Ranjan, is also here. Mangal and Ashutosh are there. Match referee is going to toss the coin. Mangal is going to call. Heads.
Patna ke captain ne kaha heads.
Tail.
It is tails. Ashutosh, aap jeete hain, to aap toss jeet kar pehle kya karna chahenge?
Hum toss jeet kar bowling karenge.
Uska karan?
Uska karan hum teen medium pacer se khel rahe hain aur fresh wicket hai, thoda grass bhi hai. To koshish karenge ki jitna kam se kam total pe rok sake.
Aur wo kam se kam total aap kya sochte hain kitne tak rok lenge aap unko?
140 to 150.
Bihar Cricket League finally aa gayi hai. Kitna romanch, kitne utsahit?
बहुत उत्साहित हूँ. इतना अच्छा ऑर्गेनाइज़ किया गया है ये टूर्नामेंट, हमारे लिए बहुत अच्छा प्लेटफॉर्म है. लाइव मैचेस हैं यहाँ पे, जो भी एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी परफॉर्म करेगा उसे हर कोई देखेगा कंट्री में. और इसी टाइप के लीग केपीएल और टीएनपीएल से कई लड़के आईपीएल के लिए भी सेलेक्ट हुए हैं. उम्मीद करते हैं हम में से भी अगले साल.
ऑल बेस्ट.
थैंक यू.
मंगल, आप बल्लेबाजी कर रहे हैं मोर आउट ऑफ कंपल्शन देन चॉइस, क्योंकि आप टॉस हार गए. आप अगर टॉस जीतते तो आप क्या करते?
मैं भी पहले गेंदबाजी करता.
उसका कारण?
कोशिश ये रहती हमारी कि मैं कम टोटल पे रोक कर एक टारगेट चेज करके अच्छा रहता टीम के लिए. हमारी बैटिंग स्ट्रेंथ काफ़ी अच्छी है.
ये विकेट में जो काफ़ी घास नज़र आ रही है, ये कितनी परेशानी का सबब बन सकती है आपके लिए?
वो खेलने के बाद पता चलेगा.
अच्छा, जब आप खेलेंगे क्या स्कोर सोच रहे हैं? ओपोनेंट्स के लिए काफ़ी होगा.
हम चाह रहे हैं 160 एबव ही स्कोर कोशिश करें बनाने का हम लोग.
तो ऑल द बेस्ट, हैव अ रॉकिंग स्टार्ट.
थैंक यू सर.
Well, the news from the center is that the captain from Angika Avengers has won the toss and he has decided to bowl first.
Well, 160 is what Patna Pilots are looking at. In Patna Pilots in red will be batting first. Angika Avengers have won the toss and decided to bowl first, and let Patna Pilots set the target. Alongside Padamjit Serawat, I'm Ravi Kant Singh. Padam, hot out there in the middle?
Yeah, out there, and we are looking at the team lineup. Starting 11 for both sides. Raju Ashwani will be coming back to that because players are ready. We are ready. Are you ready? Have you just ordered for your cup of coffee, your popcorns? Ravi and I are having it in the commentary box. We're going to have a lot of fun right till the start. For those of you who have just joined in, let me just update you. Patna Pilots lost the toss. That's the reason they are batting first. But sometimes it can be a blessing in disguise as well. I am going to use my wit and I'm going to use Ravi Kant Singh's experience in the commentary box. And Siddharth is going to be the next voice that you're going to hear in today's games right here from the commentary box. Plus, every now and then we'll be getting you some surprises as well. We are all set. This is going to be Angika Avengers bowling first, Patna Pilots batting first. Bowlers just striding up, batsmen saying, "All right, I'm not ready yet." And the first ball becomes so very crucial of any tournament because the first is always the first. And the first edition of Bihar Cricket League is right here for all of you. We're bringing it live from the Urja Stadium in Patna. There are two bowlers. Along with Ravi Kant Singh, I'm Padamjit Sharawat, and we welcome you. As we told you a short while back, this is going to be a double header game. The first one that it's going to be, players are warming up. Initial start, good start is very important. I was talking to Danny Morrison, the mentor for Patna Pilots, Ravi, a short while back, and he was very, very excited about this one.
Well, T20 is always going to be something that to keep you excited and involved. As we see Gaurav Kumar now all set, shot number 9 for Angika Avengers. Gaurav Kumar bowling to Vijay Bharti. First one and
wicket on the first ball. Would you believe it? The sort of a start that any team was, the sort of a start that no batsman would want. He came, he's going back empty-handed.
Well, there you have it. Just the edge and straight into the hands of slip, taken very well by the Suraj. It is Suraj Kashyap who pouched that one at the lone slip position. Now, how often do you see that? First ball slash and Padam. Vijay Bharti gone with no score.
Go break. 10 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1
and we are back. Gaurav struck on the very first ball, dismissing Vijay Bharti, and this is the reason why we are having a new batsman right here in the center. Oh, just wanted to poke at that one. This is not Facebook. Don't poke.
This is the Patna Pilots captain, Mangal Mehfur, whose Marur is now on strike, facing second ball. Batting at number 3, you face the second ball. Now, that is something that the captain never wants.
Yeah, absolutely. A rocking start for the team that won the toss. They said, okay, we're going to take the first use of the surface. We're going to use the white ball well on the grass on the surface, and that is how the first wicket fell, chasing something outside off stump, straight into the hands of a very, very eagerly waiting fielder. That one, Rahul Kumar, the fielder, and Patna, mind you, are batting first. Angika decided to bowl first. I'm Padamji Sharawat in the company of Ravikant Singh.
Urja Cricket Stadium, Bihar. This is the second cricket stadium in the city of Patna. The original one, which has hosted international cricket as well, including World Cup games, is the Moinul Haq Stadium at the other side of the city. This is on the western side. The next one from Gaurav, still in the first over. This may be the first run on the board. We'll have to wait and see what the umpires...
Yes, it is. Yes, it is, Ravi. And you predicted it right. The moment the umpire starts to spread his arms, that's only good news for one team, and that is... In fact, even when he takes his hands up in the air, that's good news for the team that's batting. So many things you can talk about this beautiful game called cricket.
Well, definitely, if the arms are stretching, not one but both, then the batting side celebrates. If only one arm is going up, then the bowling side starts celebrating.
Unless you stretch your right arm and you bang me in my face, Ravi, in the commentator's box. Well done. Cautious approach, and you can understand why. For two reasons. One, they are batting not out of choice but out of compulsion. Two, they've lost a wicket of the very first ball. I mean, we don't get to see that kind of a start, do we?
Well, definitely not. And that is certainly something that is going to put the Patna Pilots on the back foot. Although they've got their mentor with them, Danny Morrison. And they will definitely not be lacking in motivation at all.
Yeah, and the motivation can be that you being seen on Eurosports. People are watching you. Hindi mein kehte hain, jo dikhta hai, wahi bikta hai. Oh, inside edge. Lucky for him, did not roll on to the stumps. Very, very quiet proceedings here. Struggle for the team that is batting. That has been the short story so far.
Well, definitely not the start that Patna Pilots were hoping for. 5 deliveries gone, just that one single on the board of the bat and one wide contributing. But thick inside edge is gone towards the between the legs towards the short square leg fielder. Could have gone anywhere. Lucky went into a vacant area.
Five very good balls. Wicket of the first one. Lot of then an extra in the middle. First run of the bat came off the previous ball. We must say this has been a very tidy over. As non-striker says no run. 2-1.
Go break. 30 seconds on break. Engineering, police of engineering, can you send someone here upstairs? 15 seconds.
Batsman is 27, 17.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1, and we are back
to you. Welcome back on this Takata Cricket, as we call T20. Bihar Cricket League has just taken its first step. The first game of the doubleheader, that it is. Wicket falling off the very first ball. And a good start for the team that won the toss and decided to bowl first. Angika Avengers, their captain Ashutosh. Did not mince words at the toss. He was very certain what he wanted to do. Rahul coming into bowl the second over. They have a slip. They have a point. Now, mind you, in the first six overs, you can only take two fielders outside the 30-yard circle. And then once those six overs are completed, then you have to have four men inside the 30-yard circle at all given situations during the match. Rahul Kumar representing Angika Avengers. Five teams in the tournament. To begin a fresh over, Rahul is all set. Wrapped on the pads, leg by yet again. But when they say when there's so much of drought around, any which way that they come, they are most welcomed.
Definitely hoping to get a move on their Patna Pilots, because this kind of a start wouldn't help their cause. Remember, they have been asked to bat first, and they will be setting the target. It's that flick off the front pad. In fact, the bowler, Rahul, went up in a peel as well, although not much excitement. It was more out of, you know, anticipation.
More out of anxiousness also, because you are being seen on national television. People are watching you. The league has just begun. There's so much of anticipation and excitement around it. You know, Ravi, I was talking to Danny Morrison also before the toss, and he was very certain. He said that the news from everyone around who played cricket on the surface is that it might not come nicely onto the bat, which is absolutely true. The previous ball that we saw had a parabola, sort of a bounce on that one, the tennis ball bounce that we talk about.
Well, that always happens on a new surface, because not many people have played top-level cricket here. So there is going to be a bit of a issue with the bounce, and people are trying to work things out as soon as they can. And in fact, winning the toss may have just given that little bit of an edge to Angika Avengers. Angika, again from the eastern part of Bihar.
Well, bold, well played. You've studied in the city, haven't you?
Well, spent five glorious years in the city, and definitely those days, this stadium was not even heard of. There was only one cricket stadium, one stadium in the city, which was the Mohan Lakh Stadium. This has come up. And Rahul Kumar trying to keep the runs quiet.
And in the history also, this is the Urja Stadium. We were talking to Ravi Kant Singh about how he spent his five glorious years. Now, that's another glorious delivery that comes in and comes in sharply. You know what? That takes me down to a very beautiful stat Girish has just told me. And that is 1983, remember, they had one Bihar lad in the World Cup winning team. That was Kirti Azad. Before that, we've not heard too many players playing from this region. And from there on, once you have one hero emerging, then later on we saw MSD.
But Padam, I would call Kirti Azad adopted son of Bihar, because he's never studied or never lived in Bihar.
He played for Bihar?
No, he played all his cricket for Delhi.
Well done. But there's something called roots. And his roots strongly belong to Bihar. You can't deny that. You can't take that away.
Definitely not. I mean, his father was the member of parliament from Bhagalpur. One of the teams printing here. And he himself contested elections from Darbhanga, another team in the fray. Five delivery gone. Still just that one leg by of the first ball. So Angika Avengers wouldn't mind anything. Single of the last ball, and will they come back for the second? No. So it's 4-1 after 2 overs.
All right, 2 overs gone. The team that decided to bowl first is completely ruling the roost at the moment. They have been very miserly. They have only leaked 4 runs so far. They picked up that very vital wicket that they got at the first ball of the innings. Rahul has also bowled very miserly, giving away. And there he comes yet again. I'm Padamjit Chirawat in the company of Ravi Kant Singh.
Well, just 2 runs of those 4 off the bat. So that tells its own story. And this will be another dot ball. 2 runs have been extras, one leg by and one wide. And Patna Pilots nearly now paying the penalty of losing that early wicket. Everything too quiet.
Yeah, they need more than a couple of pilots at the moment, because at the moment it is dwindling in the air. Their aeroplane. Well done. Beautiful to watch. Straight drive, but with a lot of bottom end on it. 4 runs, the first run of Bihar Cricket League. This is super.
Really a treat to watch when the batsman hits that ball straight and shows the maker's name to the bowler. The ball going ramrod straight past the mid-off fielder. No chance for anyone whatsoever.
Normally when we hit a straight drive, it's more of the bottom hand. But that time around, there was a lot of bottom hand there. Top hand normally dominates when you play the cover drive, the straight drive. And there he goes. Over mid-off, there's a chase, but he only watches it sail. One bounce into the fence, another boundary, 2 back-to-back 4s. And this is the sort of a start they wanted.
Well, definitely, they are now getting a move on. Over number 3 in progress. First 2 overs yielded just 4 runs. And now, all of a sudden, they have decided to break loose. Sashim Rathore, with those 2 boundaries, has moved on to 9.
He is not done yet. That's high up in the air. Is he going to perish? Tough chance. Oh, goes in vain. It was tough because when you run backwards and the ball's coming over your shoulder, and was he staring into the sun as well? That's another aspect we would like to look into.
Well, definitely not the easiest of chances. Coming over your shoulder and looking back into the sun made things so much more difficult. But Sashim Rathore has had enough. He is definitely not going to hang around. Very, very tough one.
It was a chance, but that was a very good effort. But it's a cruel world that we stay in. Would still go down as a drop catch. Tough one though, very tough.
Well, 9 runs already off the over. Make that 10 now. Easy single. Third over has proved to be really now changing gears for Patna Pilots. 10 runs already, one more delivery to come.
Very enterprising over this. Though the best moment for the fielding side came of the very first ball of the innings. But 2 boundaries in this over, 1 dropped catch, the batting side would say, all right, we don't mind the 10-run over so far. Here comes the last ball of the third over of the first game of a doubleheader. taps it, takes the single. That's how you make the over big. Two boundaries, three singles, well done. Over finishes. After three, it's 15 for one. Now they are very happy, especially with the last over coming for 11 runs. Earlier, first two overs did not go their way. But that's how the game goes, because you can never rival the mystery of live sport. It'll keep surprising you, keep you on the edge of your seat, especially the shortest version of the game so far. Punches well. Straight to the man, though.
Well, definitely now the Angika Avengers have got to get more organized, because last over showed the intent from Shashim Rathore, and he has kept the strike with the single of the last ball. So Mangal Mahror, the captain, would be pretty happy watching from the non-striker's end, because Shashim has really got to move on. Can Rahul peg him back? That's going to be the big question.
Using a lot of bottom hand, not exactly where he wanted to hit that one. Mid-wicket comes into the picture, picks the ball, sends it back. Intent is a crucial word in sport, Ravi, and that intent is now visible.
Well, definitely the intent is very, very positive, especially from Shashim Rathore. Mangal Mahror hasn't had too much of the strike. He just faced six deliveries. But now it's his turn, the captain, to show the way to the Patna Pilots. Remember, these matches are being played at the Urja Stadium in Patna.
Oh, well bowled. As they always say, that's the corridor of uncertainty. If you know what to leave, the coaches tell you, you obviously know what to play.
Do you leave any deliveries in T20?
Sometimes you do. Sometimes you give respect to bowlers, because the wicket is conducive to fast bowling. And sometimes you buy the time out, you give respect and you only hit the loose balls. Yes, you do.
Well, definitely this one had him completely foxed, Mangal, expecting the ball to come in, but a shade moving away, just a shade. Rahul Kumar definitely asking tough questions.
Apesh, oh, that's a beauty. What a catch that is. Jaunty Rhodes, are you watching from some part of the world somewhere? You would want to watch that replay time and again. When the cover drive was hit, we thought the music and the beats only meant for the batsman, but that was not to be. When you watch that replay, you come to realize what a brilliant catch that was. Till that point, we thought it was a good shot. It just might go over, but there he dives onto the right. Airborne, picks it from thin air. Well done, young lad.
Well, that is the end of Mangal. Gone for two of seven deliveries. So Patna Pilots lose their captain, Mangal Mahror, and now it is going to be a tough one for Patna Pilots to come back. So Mangal Mahror gone for two. Patna Pilots now 16 for two.
Back 16 for 2. Just when we were waxing a lot of eloquence on the batting side, they have been nipped in the bud yet again. Why? How? There was a diving catch from the cover fielder, diving onto his right, picking it from thin air, dismissing the batsman, and that brings in Saqib Ul Ghani.
Well, you got one man going hammer and tongs, Shashim Rathore, at one end. But wickets falling at the other end. This is the wicket for you. square drive was on, there was width, but a great diving catch moving to his right. Padam looks very, very athletic.
Acrobatic, athletic, awesome. I mean, we can run out of adjectives, but that was just superlative. I'm sure when our editor, who makes the short promos and packages, he surely would have kept it with him, the EVS operator.
Well, definitely, last ball of the over. This time, pushing it between, trying to push it between cover and point, single. So that's four overs gone, 17 for two.
Last over, very good. Two runs, one wicket, and that's the reason the team that was forced to bat first because they lost the toss. Patna Pilots at the moment find themselves at 17 for 2. Shaheem is batting on 12 from 13. Saqibul has just come in to bat. I'm Padamji Charawat in the company of Ravi Kant Singh.
Well, definitely, Patna Pilots have got a lot of rebuilding to do. Four runs and over or thereabouts won't really trouble the opposition. And the Patna Pilots captain, Mangal Mehroor, had said they're looking at about 160. And they're nearly falling short already. New over from Gaurav Kumar, his third.
But I'm told they have a very good batting lineup. Sometimes you have cricket as a game, and any sport as a game, Ravi, you would know this. You've covered sport so many years. You have phases. One phase that goes for you, the next phase goes to the other team, and then sometimes the seesaw battle keeps going on. And on a surface like this, where the ball is not coming nicely onto the bat, a score of 135, 140 can be a very good score too.
Well, this is those kind of totals which the chasing side may not really be troubled, but then a few wickets and things could just turn around.
The history of cricket and the history of short ball cricket, short format cricket, is that the most interesting encounters have been the low scoring encounters. So far, story no doubt belongs to the fielding side, the boys in red and black.
Well, they are Angika Avengers from the eastern part of the state. Patna Pilots, of course, belong right here to the city.
You came here. It's been a day that you've been here. Tasted Litti Chokha?
Not yet.
How can you deprive yourself of that, Ravi?
Well, you've got seven more days.
Okay. They can't wait for their Litti Chokha. Their Litti Chokha is going to be the boundaries and the sixes.
Well, definitely.
As spicy as they come, we don't mind it.
Well, definitely. They would love to get a lot of green on the ball, get those boundaries away. But at the moment, it is Shashim Rathore alone fighting a lone battle. How far can he take them? That's going to be the question.
Bihar Cricket League, an initiative of BCA and Elite Group. Great initiative. They have, they're trying to unearth some gems. And that's what tournaments such as this, they provide right at the end of the day. By the time we arrive to the 26th, when we will have the big final, we would have shortlisted some players who can and seen be heard in the future to come.
There is plenty of talent right all around the country, and this is the kind of leagues that will throw up fresh talent. As we are in the fifth over, 18 for 2. Not the kind of start that Danny Morrison would have, and the mentor of Patna Pilots would have hoped for. But then there's a long way to go. Each team has got to play four matches, five-team league here in the Bihar Cricket League.
Yeah, and Danny Morrison also said one very important thing, was the mentor of Patna Pilots, mind you. That's the reason we are mentioning him here. He said, my team is talented, but they are more hardworking than talented. And hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard.
Well, Danny Morrison can say that and get away with it. As we draw towards the close of the fifth over. There you see Danny Morrison on the Patna Pilots bench. Hopefully we can hijack him when his team is not in action up to the commentary box.
We would love it more than ourselves. The viewers are going to love it. Delight totally cuts it. Cuts it well. He'll get a boundary on that one. Bisected the two fielders. Cover and extra cover. That's the end of the over. That takes the total to 23 for two.
You're watching live action from the Urja Stadium in the Bihar Cricket League as Padam takes a break, and I'm joined by Siddharth Mishra for the first time in this tournament. Loving the sunshine, Siddharth?
Yes, but I guess right now there's only one team on top, and until now I feel, Ravi, that it's a job well done by the bowling team. They've kept it tight, and it's been hard work for the batsmen until now, barring Shashim Rathore, who has a fair amount of experience, made his debut in his home state of Jharkhand, and after cricket was reinstated in the state of Bihar, he made his way to Bihar, and now he is, in a way, he's got a great body of work behind him. Beats the gap. That's well done again by the batsman, and that spears the offside field for a very well-deserved boundary.
Rahul is now bowling his third over. First two overs have just cost him three runs. And giving the batsman width, now that is invitation for punishment.
That's a cardinal sin, Ravi, isn't it? In T20 cricket, until now, the bowling has been tied. Gaurav has been bowling tight lines into the batsman. But that was just easy pickings for the batsman over there.
Men in red, Angika Avengers, Rahul. Playing it cleverly down to third man, will pick up the single. And that is a clever batting ploy. If you can't get the boundaries, at least get those singles, and that will get the scoreboard ticking. That was Shashim Rathore. And now it's Shakibul Ghani on strike. He's already got six at runner ball. And so that the important thing is now they've got to move on. Just four more deliveries left in the power play, and then the field spreads out.
Absolutely, but it's also like a catch-22 situation for them. Already lost two wickets. Nicely done. Just what you mentioned, Ravi. Just keeping the scoreboard ticking. Paramount importance in limited overs cricket. You hit a boundary, but just make sure you're not stuck at the crease.
Sixth over in progress. The last over of the power play. Haven't really seen the batsman going hammer and tongs just yet. Oh, tucked him up very well. Good ploy there from Rahul. Getting the ball to come in rather sharply. He's given away six runs, but his captain wouldn't mind.
It's been a good bowling performance, hasn't it been, Ravi, until now? The bowlers, they've stuck to the line, again, bowling into the body, bowling tight lines. The other bowler, Gaurav, having the ball tail away, tail in. So it's been like a complete bowling performance until now. And in the power play, that is what you need if you're a bowling side.
Well, this is trying to hit it towards backward leg, came off the back of the bat.
That was more like pinball. It pinged away and just kind of ricocheted from another part of his body and went to the offside.
Certainly Fox, the wicketkeeper. That's the wicketkeeper for Angika Avengers. He was almost down to leg slip when he realized the ball wasn't going anywhere close to him.
Well, it's all happening here at the inaugural Bihar Cricket League. It's a red letter day for Bihar cricket as the very first match between Angika and Patna is underway here at the Urja Stadium.
Very close to that line. One more delivery to go in this power play. 31 for 2. Now, that's not the kind of start that Patna Pilots would have hoped. But with one more delivery, how many can they get? That's going to be to end the first 6 overs of power play.
As Ashutosh Aman, the captain of Bihar. In fact, he was the first player to be picked up at the auction.
So ends the power play with a dot ball. 31 for 2 at the end of the first power play. 6 overs gone. Well, power play done and dusted for Patna Pilots, and at the moment they will not be really celebrating in that dugout, although Shashim Rathor has done his job pretty well. 19 of 18 deliveries as we've got a bowling change for Anka Avengers. It's Krishna Oja. Krishna Oja lining up from the end that Gaurav Kumar was bowling.
Nicely played by Shashim, but now the power play is over, so you have the boundary rider over there. Enough time for the batsman to come for a single. So at the end of the power play, what do you reckon, Ravi? Honours even or it's advantage bowling team and advantage Angika Avengers?
Well, the two wickets have certainly put Patna Pilots back, but Shashim Rathore has been fighting a lone battle. He had those two glorious hits to the fence and definitely put some pressure on Angika Avengers, scoring 31 for the loss of those two wickets. Krishna Kumar continues. The singles will now come in much easier.
Absolutely. The field is no longer up. But there you go. That's the coach of Angika Avengers.
Subrata Banerjee played for India in Test match cricket and was a fairly sharp seam bowler from Jamshedpur. And definitely his bowlers are showing what he has trained them with.
Well, there's a cricket trivia for all of you over there. Subrata Banerjee, in his first test match at SCG, bowled a spell, and just as we speak, that's hoiked away. But only towards the fielder, the batsman would just come for the single. Subrata Banerjee also was a part of the 1992 World Cup. And Ravi, apart from that, in his debut match at the SCG, he got the likes of Jeff Marsh, Mark Taylor and Mark Waugh, and never played a test match after that for India.
Well, that's what life is. Subrata Banerjee helped Sachin Tendulkar get over that wrist injury and come back strongly into the Indian team. So he's got a lot of history going for him, Subrata Banerjee.
Oh, that's played into the gully region. Just nicked it in a way, but well fielded there by the gully fielder. No run. Well, there's also another fact that Arjun Tendulkar, he was brought under the wings of Subrata Banerjee at the behest of Sachin Tendulkar. So there you go. There are a lot of tales about a man who you can probably say couldn't realize his true potential in international cricket.
Well, definitely Subrata Banerjee had lots going for him, but unfortunately didn't get the nod from these men who mattered. At the moment, the men who matter are right there in the middle. trying to get a move on for Patna Pilots. Shakibul Ghani will push this one to long on for a single. 35-2.
What do you reckon, Ravi? What should be the strategy now? Because in a way, 16 to the 16th over, I beg your pardon, 6th to the 16th over is like a little bit of a slow phase. I can't believe I'm saying that in a T20 game. It's a little bit of a slow phase where the team batting needs to consolidate, would want to keep wickets in hand. What do you reckon? How would they go about things?
Well, they definitely need to consolidate, but also keep those singles and twos coming. Otherwise, they could be falling well behind what they intended target. Last ball of the over coming up. Another dot ball to end the over. 35-2 after 7.
So, 7 overs gone. This is the inaugural match of the Bihar Cricket League. The first match of this doubleheader is between the Patna Pilots and the Angakai Avengers. Angakai Avengers, the captain Ashutosh Aman won the toss and inserted Patna Pilots to bat. They've lost 2 wickets after 7 overs with only 35 on the board, barring Shashim Rathore, who has a fair amount of matches for Bihar in the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy and the Vijay Hazare Trophy, has been going well in a, compared to the others, in a slightly more belligerent fashion, but still, I would say at 35-2 after 7 overs, that's not a great run rate to have at this point in time, Ravi.
And for the first time, we're about to see some spin in the form of the Angika Avengers skipper. Left arm orthodox is what he's going to send down. After 7 overs of seam bowling from Angika Avengers, and only one of them was really taken to the cleaners. That was 11 runs of Gaurav Kumar's second over when Shashim Rathore got after him and hit those 2 boundaries. Apart from that, we've had a bit of a drought.
Cut away, but only to the inner circle. Well, things have been tough for the batting side. Things have been tough for Patna Pilots until now. And I'm guessing it's going to get even tougher because Ashutosh Aman is a very, very stingy operator. Captain of Bihar, apart from that, Ravi, in the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy, all the 5 matches they played in their plate group, he was the top wicket taker, in fact, in the tournament. Had 16 wickets in the kitty, operating miserly at an economy of just over 5.
Well, that certainly is a great bowling by a spinner in this shortest format of the game. Again, a bit of room outside the off stump, and Shakibul Ghani would probably feel he's missed out on an opportunity.
Well, that is really strange because that one really, really kept low. And I think this is the reason. This is the reason now teams on a fresh wicket want to insert the opposition because they just exactly don't know.
Ashutosh trying to use the angle there, trying to bring the ball in, but Shakibul was up to the challenge, just pushed it up away for a single. Moves on to 10. Subrata Banerjee will be pretty satisfied with the outcome from his bowlers so far.
Short, not short enough, and again another dot ball. Patna must be realizing they need to get a move on. Again, it's a catch-22 situation. The run rate is not too much. They would want to go for the boundaries, but at the same time, they would not want to lose more wickets.
The man at the cover will pick it up, but just a single second run would have been dangerous. So 8 overs gone, 38 for 2, Patna Pilots.
Right, so 8 overs gone, 38 for 2 right now.
Okay.
Shakib Ul Ghani, well, he would like to really, really put up a good performance. He's the namesake of a very, very good all-rounder in the form of Shakib Ul Hasan. So he would want to, if not replicate, at least just try to get near the kind of performances the Bangladeshi all-rounder puts in. At this point in time, it's Krishna again back into the attack.
Well, first over, he went for 4 runs. So, if he can keep it down to that, his captain won't be too annoyed. First one goes behind the stumps. 4 runs. Welcome boundary for Patna Pilots. Doesn't matter how they come.
Yes, that went off the glove, Ravi, over there. But, well, runs are welcome all the time, no matter how they come. And that was a touch lucky over there. Had that just brushed the glove, probably that would have gone to the keeper. But thankfully for him, there was decent amount of impact on the glove. And that's why it just lobbed over the wicketkeeper over there. 4 more runs to the batting side.
Welcome runs definitely for Patna Pilots. Move on to 42 now. We are in the 9th over. Once again, the boundary rider comes into play, keeping the scoring down to just a single. The boundaries haven't been coming at all for Patna Pilots, and now they've got to start scratching their heads how to get move on. Because both batsmen are now set. They've faced about 15-plus balls each, 23 for Shashim Rathore. Shakib Ul Ghani has faced 18.
Yes, Ravi, one thing we haven't seen from them is being adventurous until now. That one, although was a little adventurous, played over the square leg region, but the boundary rider comes in and the batsmen have enough time to come for a single.
Well, one thing's got to be said about Shashim Rathore. That was very cleverly played. He held that shot back, didn't go through with his shot, otherwise it may have carried... Right there, and there you see former India captain Kapil Dev in attendance, was part of the inaugural ceremony. And obviously, when cricket is around, how can Kapil Paji not be around? He must enjoy the action. Unless he can hit the golf course.
And that's fantastic, isn't it? Every time a stalwart gets associated with a game, and particularly with an inaugural T20 league, obviously it gets eyeballs. And of course, Kapil Dev, the cynosure of all eyes. And that, I'm sure, would translate onto the Bihar Cricket League as well.
The recently has been elected to the board of the PGTI, the Professional Golf Tour of India. And don't forget, he's also donned the East Bengal jersey as a footballer. So that's the kind of CV, if we can call it.
Well, that's been hoiked, and that almost was into the face of the fielder right at the last moment. He just kind of balanced himself. That was hit hard, but only for a single over there. Yes, of course, Kapil Dev, I mean, you call him an all-rounder. There you go. He's an all-rounder, not just of the game of cricket, but he's an all-rounder of various sports, I guess.
I think the saying goes, if you play a ball game, you're good at just about everything.
I think you can rather say for him, he's not a jack of all trades and master of none. He is a master of all trades and master of all.
Well, definitely. I mean, when it comes to sports, very few can surpass Kapil Paji. Chance of...
Oh, that was close. Just had one stump to aim at. and he missed it. They try this in the fielding drills all the time, but over there he missed it, and a result of that is in fact overthrows. That's the end of the over. 9 overs gone. It's 47 for 2.
Well, Ashutosh Aman will continue. His first over cost mere 3 runs. So 47 for 2 at the end of 9. Ooh, that one nearly sneaked through.
Ashutosh Aman, a very, very clever operator. Very clever. As I mentioned earlier, he is miserly in the Syed Mushtaq Ali also. He operated at an economy of just a shade over 5, and over here he's just showing what a wily old fox he is. And that one, well, that fox, the keeper as well, and that's gone for 4.
Well, is it buys? No, it hit the bottom of the bat, so can't really hold the keeper responsible for that one, because those deflections are absolutely impossible. Got the end of the toe end of the bat, went between the keeper's gloves and the pad. 4 runs nonetheless for Patna Pilots. And that also brings up the 50 for Patna Pilots, 51 for 2.
Well, as the great Jeffrey Boycott would have said, well, that was a Chinese cut. The Chinese cut going for a boundary. Charges well and hits it over the extra cover region for 4 runs. That's well done by Shakib Ul Ghani. Now upping the ante are Patna Pilots, and that was hoiked really well over the extra cover region for 4.
Well, they need plenty of those, because they are at the moment way behind the 9 ball, as they would say. And they need to start taking risks now, because we are already in the 10th over. And the score languishing at 55.
I think now with the passage of time, Ravi, I think they're growing in confidence. Initially, they were a little jittery. Obviously, inaugural edition of the Bihar Cricket League. It's also the occasion at times which gets the better of you. Maybe some of them were overawed. But now, the fact that now they've eased into this competition, they're starting to gain some momentum.
More of your Chinese cut there, Siddharth.
Jeffrey Boycott would be proud of it.
Partnership with 41 now. Last wicket fell at the score on 16. That was Mangal Mahroor. That was way back in the 4th over. Certainly looks like a long, long time ago.
Yes, long time ago. But now this, they've bolstered a good stand over here. There's the Bihar captain into him. And do you reckon the ball is stopping a bit?
Not just stopping, but for Ashutosh Aman, the ball is just keeping low. And one more delivery to come in this over. A bit of a chat among the bowlers. And Paz has called it. So 10 overs gone, 57 for 2.
Welcome back, folks. It's Bihar Cricket League time. And with me in the comm box now, I have Padamjeet Sehrawat. Padam, welcome. Welcome back.
Thank you so much. And 57 for 2. Exactly, remember, Siddharth, the first ball did not go their way. Then there was a face that did not go their way. But what we are now getting to see is intent. He's talking to the wicketkeeper. always nice to something or the other is always the bowler's trying to adjust his field. So excitement will always rule the roost right here in Bihar Cricket League. Are you excited? Are you enjoying your brief stay so far?
Absolutely, absolutely. And you know, it's amazing. You're talking about, you know, various stories. We always talk about Test cricket having a narrative to it, but T20 also, it's like a micro plot, and there are so many things happening.
I think as he plays it to the onside, takes a single. Test cricket has benefited a lot from T20 cricket.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that's why you have four-day matches. You have matches finishing off in 3 days. Well, the matches that finish in 2 days, that's obviously not because of the T20 cricket, but pitches these days that have been garnering so much of flack. But yes, T20 surely has changed the approach of the game, even in Test cricket.
And he wants to change the approach of the batsman there, the bowler's trying to adjust his field. So, yeah, we've started to have more results since the introduction of T20. Test cricket has produced more results, taps it, takes a single yet again. Now, as you can see, rightly, they're concentrating on taking the singles. Very soon, they'll have to realize that they'll have to use the good old golf swing, high back lift, full follow-through kinds, because they have to score in the region of 155-160.
Again, getting the leading edge. Has he got enough bat on it? He has! Goes over the long on-fielder initially. My feeling was probably he hasn't connected that well enough, but that's gone over the long on fielder above Ashutosh Aman for a six.
My feeling wasn't different to yours. I mean, exactly the same. I thought he'll be caught right there, and he was very, very eager, very, very... The jump was there too, but it sailed over him.
Sometimes these are the catches, you know, you see so often now these days in T20 cricket. But that just evaded him by probably a few inches.
Just it wished he was just 1 feet taller, nothing more. Not that he doesn't have a good height now. But good captains always, that's a 50-run partnership. Congratulations. This has come to their aid. The amazing action by the bowler. What he does is he doesn't give the ball too much of loop. He's more of a sidearm bowler.
Probably the left-arm counterpart of Kedar Jadhav, is he? He's also like, you know, a little slingy, like him.
Yeah, the analogy is right. But he bowls at a faster pace. Kedar is slowest. If he's slow, he's slowest. And that's the last ball of the over. They've taken a cheeky single. 11 overs gone, 68 for 2.
Right, guys, welcome to the Bihar Cricket League. It's a double-header day today. It's match number one happening right now between the Angika Avengers and Patna Pilots. The toss was won by the Angika Avengers, and they put the opposition in. And right now, they have been going along nicely with this 52-run partnership.
And just 44 balls. And we are just showing you some shots from this partnership. They cut very well. They found the gaps very well. And then he was brave enough to jump down the track and take it over mid-off as well. And then when anything was pitched on the leg side, 30-yard circle was used very well. And this was beautiful batting. I mean, wait for the loose ball. Whenever you get it, you capitalize on it. Back to live. Now, this is not part of the package. Highlights package over. A good 50-run partnership, isn't it?
Yes, and now certainly they are just gaining confidence now. Initially, they were jittery. They were a little nervous about the proceedings. But now, Shakibul and Shashim both have been going well. It's not the kind of run rate which you would say is in stratosphere. But this one... just a little short of the fielder over there, and then he collects a single rather easily.
Yeah, and every run that you add to the bank, later on you may just be able to give a loan to your opponents. If you don't have anything in the bank, how will you give the loan to somebody? We're just trying to have a little bit of fun as we take a good shot this. With that one shot, we've shown the kind of field placement that they're trying to implicate. what we also might tell you at this moment is that in the first six overs are on, you can only have two men outside the 30-yard circle. Once those six overs have finished, then you have to have four men inside the circle, which then means that you can have five men patrolling the boundary line. Great camera work, this. And, you know, fantastic coverage, this. And this is the time when we need to salute the effort of our producer, director, EVS operator, graphics guy, cameraman. Well done, guys.
Again, trying to go for the good old Hoik over there, but not quite connecting, getting from the toe end of the back. And again, Shashim just collects another single, but moving on nicely. He's on 36 now. Comes with a fair amount of experience, Padam. Used to play for Jharkhand earlier, his native state. And then, after Bihar got their status reinstated by the BCCI, moved to Bihar.
Yeah, and another thing that sport moves you, it touches you deep down. It also teaches you it's not about I, it's about we. What we're talking about, the coverage, it's teamwork. Everyone contributes to make this coverage successful. It is not just the two or three voices that you hear today. Last ball coming up. We'll talk about it more. That's a great topic to talk on. 12 overs gone, 72 for two. Seventy-two for two. Sport builds character. Sport gives hope where once there was only despair. Sport teaches you, alone you can do so little, together you can do so much. It's not about I, it's about we. Talk about that person who's put that hoarding back. Talk about the groundsmen who actually make the surface for us. Talk about the entire crew that's working on. Talk about those guys working day in, day out to make this ground look beautiful. It is not just about what you see. Sometimes it's all also about what you don't get to see. These faces you don't get to see, but look at the effort. It's a picturesque ground. It's a beautiful field. Well done, everyone.
Yes, it's the effort. It's the intangible at times, which is not seen, but obviously it goes a long way in putting up a spectacular performance. And another intangible is urja or energy, which has been inserted by the two teams over here today, Patna Pilots and Angika Avengers. But you gotta give credit to the groundsmen, to everybody involved. Urja Stadium, or energy as they say in Hindi. Beautifully done, well manicured ground, Padam.
Absolutely, and that's exactly what the batting side needs now. They need energy. They need some, as he rightly indicated, good old golf swing, high backlift, full follow-through kinds. Great camera work yet again. And we're showing you two things there. The ground is very beautiful and the field placement. Ek teer se do nishana, Hindi mein, as we call it. Sweeps it. Well, how many runs is going to get? Just one, because the man has been stationed very, very well.
And both these teams, they in a way have an embarrassment of riches. When it comes to Patna Pilots, they have the likes of Shashim Rathore, Mangal Mehrur, who's the captain. He also played a fantastic knock in the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy when they were knocked out by Rajasthan in the quarterfinal. He's a hard-hitting batsman. Not just him. And that one, just as I speak, has been hit towards extra cover. Thought that'll go for a boundary, but they just collect a single.
Yeah, and surprise element. You thought something else happened. And that's the reason I always say you can never rival the mystery of live sport. So far, this has been a quiet over. Just four runs off it. One extra, three from the willow. Jumps down the track, places it, rotates the strike. Keeps strike because that's the last ball of the over. 77 for two.
Right then, Patna Pilots, 77 for 2 right now. Shashim Rathore, 38 of 35 deliveries. Shakibul Ghani, I was just about to say Shakibul Hassan, but Shakibul Ghani, 33, almost a runner ball 33 right now. But what we've seen in the past few overs is intent from the Patna Pilots. The run rate still not skyrocketing, but now this is the time when they can up the ante in the remaining 7 overs and get their team to a total which would be a rather respectable one.
Yeah, good to see that people are coming in and watching cricket. Also from your homes, your drawing rooms on Eurosport. The first game, great aerial view that of how the field placement is. Point, cover, extra cover, deep third man. Oh, well done, I like it. We've seen a lot of this recent times. That's the introduction of modern sport, modern era.
Shades of Rishabh Pant in that. Well, of course, Dilshan came with the Dil scoop, but this ramp shot was very, very a la Rishabh Pant. Wasn't it, Padam?
Treat to watch. I mean, that's the reason I always say change is the only constant. We don't mind this. I mean, if you get out on a shot like that, your captain and your coach will absolutely make life hell for you. But that's okay. To succeed sometimes and for the team's cause, you need to take such risks. That's a good shot. Now, because he's got it off the first ball of the over, let's see if he capitalizes. Cuts well. He's going to get a back-to-back boundary here. That is good batting. Back to traditional cricket to make it 8 runs of 2 balls.
That's a fantastic shot. Cut away and cut away hard over there behind square. And that's gone for a boundary. And this already, Patna Pilots already have now 8 runs of 2 balls. This could be the makings of a big over. This could be the makings of a much needed over by Patna Pilots, beg your pardon. And might just be that phase where they get the much needed fillip the innings require.
Nice to see kids in the stadium. This is where dreams are born. I always say, bring your kids to stadiums. Let them know what real sport, live sport is all about. Even if you take it professionally later or not, does not matter. Sport builds character. You learn to enjoy each other's success.
And every time, Padam, I think when you see women, when you see children in the stadium, I think it's the perfect barometer of how the sport is going. And it's going rather well. It's the inaugural Bihar Cricket League. And people have come in hordes today.
And also, we're showing you a lot of girls here. And because that's the reason the popularity of cricket in India in women's cricket is immense. I mean, those cricketers are household names. Currently, the tournament is on in Lucknow. Off the back foot, pulls it. That's the sort of a pull that actually gets you one run. Normally, it's a very difficult shot to play when you try that kind of a shot from the back foot, which goes to long on. Normally, pull shot goes from square leg to deep mid wicket to long leg.
Roger Federer would have been proud of it. But at this point in time, it was Shakib Ul Ghani who was proud of it. Krishna, he's into his third over. He's conceded 22, and this one could be a big over. A big over for Patna Pilots. And this could just change the tide for them. It's Shashim Rathor batting on 38. Well, that was... Oh, that's gone. Gone in the inner circle over there. He tried to go over the fielder over there, but couldn't manage to go over him. And lobs an easy catch to the fielder. And with that, Patna lose their third wicket.
Change of pace. Roll the wrist over that one. And that, clearly you can see. Quicker off spin. Lobs it straight to the man. Easy dolly. You don't get them as easy as that ever. They wanted that breakthrough. Shakib Ul goes back to the hut. He scored 38 from 36.
Welcome back. Patna Pilots have just lost their third wicket in the form of Shashim Rathore trying to hit that one over the inner circle, but the ball stopped on him a little bit, courtesy a fine slow delivery by Krishna, and that was well pouched by the fielder, resulting in the third wicket for Patna Pilots.
Akash Raj comes on to bat. He knows he's being watched on television. He's also being watched by the opponents right now. What sort of a strategy? He's got a tough task because he can't take too many balls to settle in. If they are aiming for anything around 155, 160. Oh, tries to just slice that one. Lucky did not get an outside edge on that one. 14 overs gone, 86 for 3. And we'll just take a quick look at that one, that wicket that fell, and a change of pace working. And 70-run partnership was ended by that wicket. 14 overs gone, 86 for 3.
Well, this is the fruition of a dream, the realization of a dream, Bihar Cricket League. And the first match, this is between Patna Pilots and Angika Avengers. And that was, he almost yoked himself over there. Some altercation as well between the keeper and the batsman.
Ah, we just hope they're saying, okay, how about dinner tonight? He says, no, not interested. I asked Ravi Bhai about the Litti Chokha. Have you had yours?
No, not yet, Padam.
Ravi Bhai has spent 5 of his glorious years here. He's going to take us out for dinner with Litti Chokha. In the 15th over, here we are, partnership 1 from 3 balls. And that's because the wicket, when it fell, it ended the 70-run partnership. You've got point, you've got covers, you've got third man inside the circle. So anything outside off, if he can bisect that big gap between point and third man, he'll surely fetch 4 runs.
It's a quick single over there. Well, not just a single. You have the boundary rider, so he had ample time to come back for the second. And overthrows. Overthrows over there. And that might just run to the boundary. It does. Well, that's a bonus. Absolute bonus there for the batting side over there. And that results not in 2, but in 6 runs.
Also, because the ball hit the stump, so it just might be... Oh, did he make it? But that's the best moment for them so far, because for putting in that effort, once you start to just have that energy in the legs and with those quick strides, you start to put more pressure on the bowling side. So they get 6. 2 for the 2 that they ran, and 4, luck favors the brave.
Absolutely, fortune favors the brave, and they are being brave. We have seen intent from them, and this one trying to play that cross-batted heave over the mid-wicket area, but missing that one completely. They do have a few left-arm spinning options in the form of the captain and now Sarfaraz, who's been bowling rather well. Again, trying to pierce that offside field, Padam, but not being able to get away.
And you've seen people from all age groups coming and enjoying Bihar Cricket League. Last ball of the over, taps it onto the onside. Takes the first one quickly. They're coming back for the second one as well. Putting pressure directed would have been a different story altogether. No more runs on that one. 15 overs complete. This is 95 for 3. Fifteen overs gone. Patna Pilots were made to bat first. More out of compulsion than choice. Last wicket of Shashim Rathore. 38 from 36. That ended a 70-run, very vital partnership. And that's a break for Siddharth in the commentary box. And in comes Ravikant Singh. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. And this is Krishna Oja with his fourth and final over now. Boar given away 22 runs for that one wicket of that very precious wicket of Rathore. Let's see if he can do some more damage, or will Pilots push him through? Oh, another one scooped away behind fine leg. We'll get him four. No risk, no gain.
We thought it's going to be dicey. It was spicy. Invention, thy name is adventure. Look at that. You need to be brave, Ravi. Last five overs, they need to produce runs, and that is sheer good intent.
Definitely looking to do maximum damage here. 47 for Saqibul Ghani now. Three short of the first half century of the Bihar Cricket League. 41 deliveries is what he has faced.
Oh, has he dropped it? Well fielded. Batsman 47 though, Ravi. That is where my eyes are on.
Well, was trying to pierce that gap. The ball was in the air but out of reach. No chance there for Keshav. Keshav Kumar diving. He picked up a great catch earlier to get rid of Mangal Maharoor.
That was when he dived to his right. So he can dive both sides. Point and a backward point inside the 30-yard circle, scores 99. He goes aerial, he goes big, he goes long. That's sailing into the side screen, and that is 50 for the batsman, and that is 100 for the team.
What a way to bring up the team's 100 and his personal 50. A milestone indeed. The first batsman to get a half century in the Bihar Cricket League. Saqibul Ghani had a slow start, but then once he put his foot on the pedal, looks like he's never taken it off.
And that was pure timing. I mean, he did not give it all. It was just a flick of a wrist. And then he says, okay, that's enough. Why do I need to make more effort when even this fetches me 6 runs? Bowler has more purpose at this moment. Another one. Straight down to the man. Well fielded. Judged the bounce very well. I'd like to say it was a little fortuitous because the bounce took the ball straight into the fielder's hands there.
Well, definitely Saqibul Ghani now going to try and hit just about everything out of the ground, and the way he times that cricket ball could be a lot of trouble for Angika Avengers. Captain Ashutosh Aman has got plenty to think about because he's got one more over to bowl and one more left-arm spin from Ashraf as well.
And when you start to show positive intent, sometimes then things start to happen for you. You take the first one quick, you force the fielders to make a fumble, the fumbles created, you convert the 1 into 2. This over has already yielded 12 runs so far, Ravi. Would you want to take a prediction of what's going to happen on this ball?
Well, I think it's going for a boundary.
Oh, that's a brave one. Okay, Ravikant Singh, this over is going to yield 16 runs because he says the last one's going to go for a boundary. We've got sheer excitement coming your way as Saqibul on 54 is already. And where can he go? He can go over mid-wicket. He can go over extra cover, long off on the fence, long on the fence, fine leg inside the 30-yard circle. That is exactly where he goes. Ravikant Singh, you've got Saraswati Mata residing on your tongue.
Well, that four brings us to the end of over number 16. 111 for three at the end of 16, Patna Pilots.
क्योंकि उसकी टाइमिंग नहीं हो रही है। ये क्या है ना, अब इसका भी टर्न नहीं है, 50 हो गया ना।
Take the fear factor out of the human mind and you are capable of achieving the unthinkable, Ravi. Because there is clarity in the mind, there's just one gear at the moment. Sixth.
Well, definitely it is sixth gear, but Akash Raj has got plenty to do. He's got to do a lot of catching up at the fourth and final over from Sarfaraz Ashraf. He's gone for 18 so far. Make that 19 now. The spinners have got to be very, very tidy.
And that's what they have been, especially right at the start, picked the wicket of the first ball. In between, there was that 70-run partnership that completely, we won't say changed the game, but they brought them back in the contest. And now, with 22 legal deliveries, you can imagine, it took me 5 seconds to calculate how many balls were remaining. My mathematics, you know me for long now, has always been very poor.
But I can bet you, when you were batting, you never made a mistake with calculating your scores.
I cannot say no to that. Now that's a great feeling. You're right. Every batsman counts a score.
Well, definitely Nakash would be counting his. He's got 11 of 8. Strike back with Saqib Ul Ghani. Now, can he make something happen? Well, there we see. Goes high in the air. There is a man coming under it, but he can only watch it sail over as the ball bounces out of the ground now. That will need some fetching.
If you hit a six on, long on or mid-wicket, you would say the bottom hand was in play. But there, this is pure cricketing shot. This is class. You need to have the shoulder placement right. You need to have the cradle right. You need to then go over. And he went big and long.
Well, 9 runs of this over so far. Sarfaraz had given away 25. First over had gone for 11, then 5 and 9. So this over is proving to be pretty, pretty expensive. And 2 more deliveries to go. Ghani facing at the moment. Full toss. Six. Went over.
Now this is the best phase of the game for them, no doubt. Partnership 40 from 18 balls. Now this is how he hit the second six. Earlier one, over extra cover this time around. Brings the bowler to ball into the stumps. Dispatches him over mid-wicket for another six. Now, we've had 2 back-to-back sixes. Ravi, last ball, what's going to happen?
Single.
Okay, let's see what's going to happen. Okay, taps it, takes a single. Well, we'll wax eloquence on you after on the other side of it. At the moment, it's 17 overs gone. 127 for 3. That Sarfaraz over went for 16. Saqib Ul is changing gears. And how? 2 back-to-back sixes. And then the smartest thing he did. And where Ravi Kansing got his prediction right for the second time in succession.
Well, Saqib Ul Ghani is making me look like a genius because he's playing right according to the script. He knows when to attack. Picked up the 16 the previous over with his 2 sixes, which has been the best over so far.
Take the credit where it's due, sir.
Well, he's got the strike, and now the fourth and final over from Ashutosh Aman, gone for 17 in his first 3. And always threatening to charge down, will start with a boundary. So that's a good start to the over by Patna Pilots and Ghani.
And that forces me, what sort of a change will the captain do now? Because that was he realized it was short, it was wide, there was a big gap there. And got that boundary. Field still stays the same. Extra cover, though, has been brought a little more towards his right. No major change, though. This is good thinking. Balls it again, but straight to the fielder. Will he take single? No, he wants to keep the strike.
Not a bad idea, actually. Has he already hit a 4, so if he can keep piercing the field, the runs will keep coming. Now the extra cover moves back. So who's going to come in? Mid-wicket has been brought in.
Now this, I think, is a golden opportunity for him to just sit and sweep. If he sweeps, Then he's got square leg next to the umpire. Fine leg inside the 30-yard circle too. Will he sweep? No, he bowls it well. According to the field, good bowling, good captaincy. Oh, the bowler's the captain.
Well, he's really bowling to his field, bowling from an angle wide of the stumps and keeping it well outside the off. So not allowing the batsman to really free his arms. Now let's see what Akash Raj can do. Well, good straight hit and long off and long on can only go and fetch the ball from outside the boundary.
They always say that's the safest area to hit the boundary. But it's the toughest too, because you need to have the bat coming straight. You need to have your position right. And then the flourish has to be good as well. Well done. Through the legs, through the arms, into the fence. Four more. Not a bad over this. Nine already from the first four. Jumps down the track. Over the bowler yet again. One bounce, four yet again. Third boundary of the over. He's changing gears. I'm actually looking at the fact Saqibul is batting well. It's rubbing onto Akash as well.
Well, as they say in Hindi, kharbuja kharbuja ko dekh kar rang badalta hai.
As I get better when you're around.
Thank you for the compliment, Padam.
Last ball of the over. Oh, he says, okay, no problem. Let's not damage them much. Dot ball to finish the over. 18 overs gone. 140 for three. Those 77 runs of Saqib came at a time when the team had their back against the wall. Chips were down, but he said, okay. And now, 23 runs required from two overs for his 100. He may get it or may not get it, but he surely has created a good chance for himself. And that will be because he'll always be remembered as the first batsman to get it, if he gets it, in the history of Bihar Cricket League.
Well, he's already the first man to get 50. And what a 50 it's been. Don't forget, he came into bat when Patna were in all sorts of trouble. Fourth over in progress, 16 for 2 the score. But he just plowed through the bowling and really took a toll on the spinners, hitting them all around the park. Those two lovely sixes in the previous over from Ashraf, really the jewel in the crown.
And he was good both sides, offside, onside. Pull was there, drive was there, cut was there. He could just produce the deft touch as well. He could jump down the track and produce doubt and insert doubt in the mind of the bowler. And sometimes you jump not to play a shot, but also just to insert the doubt. The bowler should think that you step out. Okay, here we come. Last 12 deliveries of this one. The first inning, he opens the face of the bat and will be a tad disappointed because he will be at the non-striker's end. But Akash, at the other end, is not doing bad either. 19 from 11.
Got those two boundaries in the previous over, so that would give a lot of confidence to Saqibul Ghani. Not really looking at his own personal three-figure score, but playing for the team's cause, and that Patna Pilots would not be really mind that.
Well bowled. Yorker. I mean, the best thing about it is if you get it right, this is the best ball. If you get it wrong, the margin of error is very, very minimal. I mean, you overpitch it, it's a full toss. You underpitch it, it's a half volley. So, well done. On that point, two balls, two runs. And Ravi, overall, he's done well. 3.2 overs, one wicket, 13 runs.
Yeah, he came, gave away just 11 in his first three. And a wicket to boot as well. Mangal Mahroor's wicket was what Rahul had picked up. He was bowling from the other end in his first spell. This time outside edge, straight to the third man fielder, single. So now it's back with Ghani.
Okay, Saqibul comes on strike and Akash comes on strike. Both the batsmen have been able to rotate the strike so far. And the fielding side wouldn't mind this one bit. Partnership has been 57 from 28 balls. The best of the innings in terms of the strike rate, if not in terms of the total number of runs, because remember there was this huge partnership of 70 runs. Three from three so far. Jumps down the track. He gives it all. He gets it all. That's a massive one yet again. Boy, oh boy, are they changing the complexion of this one.
149. So if the captain had said 160 or thereabouts, he wasn't too far off the mark, and his batsmen are really standing up to the challenge.
Oh, they are. They're not standing at the moment. They're jumping down the track and hoisting it, Ravi. They are saying, okay, let's be. Because at the end of the day, if you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. If you can't crawl, move. It is all about movement. Don't sit and watch. And they are moving at a rapid pace at the moment. This time around on the onside, he'll get 4. 10 runs at the last 2 balls. And that makes this over as 13 from 5 balls.
Well, first 3 overs had cost Rahul 13. First 5 balls in this over has cost him 13. So really, the death overs costing plenty to Angika Avengers. Is, you've got 2 set batsmen out there in the middle, Saqib Ul Ghani and Akash Raj.
All right, this is looking good. Akash suddenly has gone on to 30. His 30 has made such a huge difference. As we see, you've got long on deep, mid-wicket deep, you've got square leg deep, fine leg inside the 30-yard circle, had to be. 3 men patrolling boundary on the onside. This time he says, I'm going to produce the reverse. Nothing is what they say. Over completed, 19 overs gone, 153 for 3. We were talking about the pass score to be around 165, and that's exactly where it can be. Saqib Ul will now be on strike, requires 21 for that 100. May not be possible, but I mean, maybe difficult, but not impossible, Ravi.
Well, definitely not impossible. And now the final over, how many will that yield? That is going to be the big question. At the moment, we've got Gaurav Kumar marking his run-up. From the other end, he bowled his first 3 overs and went for plenty in his third over, 17. Three overs for 19, beg your pardon. So this over could be the decisive one.
Last wicket, Shashim Rathor scored 38. And this over is going to be the deciding factor because both the batsmen are timing the ball very, very well. They are producing the hard hits. They are getting runs fairly quickly. And so far, 67 runs have come from just 31 balls. So that tells you that they are scoring runs at nearly a strike rate of 12.53. 13 from the previous over. This is the last over of this innings. Well bowled. Tries to bowl a Yorker outside off. What that does is it brings Akash back on strike.
154 for 3 now in the final over. Ghani having a close look at the bottom of the bat. Seems to have done some damage there because he's been doing that for quite some time. Strike now with Akash Raj. Can Gaurav Kumar control this? Well, he's got a man at long off, so a single is all that Akash will get. And singles won't really hurt the fielding side.
Oh, they won't. And suddenly, we see that this wicket is playing a lot better now as it was right at the start. 2 balls, 2 runs. They need some big shots to finish this somewhere around 165, 167 maybe. Intent was clear. Full toss is what he gets. He only watches it sail through. That's another massive. Saqib Ul goes on to 86. The team total goes to 161. Lot of beats, lot of drums around.
Well, the excitement certainly building up. If he can still connect with that bat so well, I don't know what is he worried about, the bottom.
So what that does is it really brings the imperis back. Since the time he's got is 50, he has not wasted any time to reach on to 86. Now, three balls left. The possibility of getting two sixes and a double, Ravi?
Well, possible.
Not after that yorker. Not after that yorker.
Now, you know why Gaurav Kumar was preferred with the final, handed the final over by the captain, Ashutosh Aman, because he knew Saqib Al Ghani would try and do maximum damage. Getting him off the strike is the best way to keep things under control. But can they keep Akash Raj quiet? That's going to be the big one.
Quick confirmation at the bottom of your screen. Two more balls to come. Nine runs so far. That's a beauty. That is not just a yorker. That's also a change of pace. And that is something that flummoxes the batsman completely.
Batting on 31. Akash Raj failed to read that slower delivery. Off-spinner, and had was through with the shot by the time the ball came to him. So, no chance to connect. So, last delivery. Akash Raj is on strike. 31 of 17. How many can he get? That's going to be the big question, and I'm not going to guess this time.
Oh, he should be. Here comes the last ball of the hour. Ravi Kant has taken a back seat. Will Akash take the front seat? There, pulls it from outside off, just for a single though. This has been a good comeback for a side that was just trailing and tottering at the start, and they were finding it so difficult to meet the ball well. 77 from 37 balls, and that has put them in the driver's seat. Anjika Avengers, when they come on to bat, they'll have to chase 164 now. They had won the toss and they had elected to field. The final over of the innings, producing 10 runs. Ravi, is this chaseable?
Well, definitely. Not, we'd not say a winning total. Definitely chaseable. But part of that credit must go to Gaurav Kumar, who just gave away 10 runs in the final over. And that may not be enough for Patna Pilots. 164 is what the target they've set for Angika Avengers. And can they really... can their bowlers perform? That's going to be the big question.
Oh, this is how it has been. Saqib Al, well done. 87 from 57 balls. Akash, 32 from 18. Good little partnership. They stitched it in no nick of time. 29 for 1 for Gaurav from the 4 overs that he bowled. And they finished the total at 163-43. We'll quickly run for you the batting card, and the batting card would state that they were struggling right at the top, but there was that 70-run partnership, and that 70-run partnership was followed by an unbeaten partnership at the end.
Yeah, the unbeaten partnership was worth 77, and Saqib Al Ghani returns to the pavilion with 87 of 57, and his 50 came off 43. So the last 14 deliveries have really got him those 37 runs. Akash Raj, 32 not out, and really gave great support. Just those four extras in the entire innings, and pretty disciplined stuff dished out by Avengers. Now they'll need to bring that discipline back into the batting as well. Mangal Maroor gone for two. That was when the team was in real trouble. 16 for two, and that really got them really on the back foot.
Yeah, and this has produced a contest in the game. Looking at the bowlers, Gaurav 1 for 29, Rahul 1 for 24. And how many bowlers did he bowl? All of them. They just used five bowlers. Each bowler bowled four overs. And we are all set for a flash interview. We will not tell you who Siddharth is interviewing. Find it out for yourself. Over to you, Sid.
Well, with me, I have the hero of the first game, rather the first innings. Patna Pilots' Saqib Al Ghani is with us, who has played 83 runs, rather 87 runs, a shandar pari. Very, very good. Very big performance. You have played a great ball. But when you came to play, the situation was a little bit 20 रन के आसपास बने हुए थे, दो विकेट चली गई थी, क्या स्ट्रैटेजी बनाई थी बीच में आपने शशीम राठौड़ के साथ उस वक्त?
जी मैं गया बैटिंग करने तो सबसे पहले शशीम राठौड़ सीनियर हमसे वो बोले कि जहाँ तक जितना लंबा हो सके उतना लंबा खेलना है, बस पार्टनरशिप करते जाओ। मैंने वही सोचा और उनके साथ भी पार्टनरशिप किया, यही बात हुआ था हम लोगों के बीच।
कुछ बड़े नायाब शॉट देखने को हमारे को मिले, कुछ ट्रेडिशनल शॉट तो देखने को मिले, बट सबसे ज़बरदस्त शॉट जो मेरे को लगा वो था रैम्प शॉट, थोड़ा ऋषभ पंत के अंदाज में वहाँ पे, उसके बारे में कुछ बताइए।
जी हाँ, उस समय तो सेट हो गए थे और प्लस बात T20 गए, तो T20 में सब शॉट तो खेलना ही पड़ेगा भैया।
एक और बहुत कमाल के ऑलराउंडर हैं, उनके साथ हम नाम शेयर करते हैं, जानते हैं ना कौन है?
कौन भैया?
शाकिबुल हसन। कुछ उसी की तरह उसी शैली में आपने बल्लेबाजी की, तो देख के बड़ा मज़ा आया और बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, और आशा करते हैं कि आज का मैच जो है आपके लिए अच्छा रहे। दैट वाज शाकिबुल गानी फ्रॉम पटना पायलट्स हु प्लेड अ स्टेलर नॉक टुडे।
थैंक यू। एंड ही इज अ मैन ऑफ वेरी फ्यू वर्ड्स, बट ही सेज ओके इट्स नॉट माय वोकल्स दैट डू द टॉकिंग, माय विलो इज गुड इनफ टू कॉन्कर द वर्ल्ड।
So the target for Anka Avengers is 164, and let's see how they can do. The chase will be followed by after the break.
Right, so after a little lull in the proceedings, we are back on. It's Angika Avengers taking on the Patna Pilots in match number one of the Bihar Cricket League, the inaugural Bihar Cricket League, live from the Urja Stadium in Patna. So it's the home team versus Angika Avengers. It's the northeastern team of Angika versus the capital city of Patna. Well, that's the scorecard of the first innings. Patna Pilots, they were put into bat by Ashutosh Aman, the captain of Angika Avengers. And after a rather rickety start, things were bolstered by Shashim Rathor. And there you go, that's the fall of wickets. Initially, rickety start, but after that, there was consolidation from the batsmen.
Well, they lost two wickets for the first 16 runs, and then thereafter, good repair work from Shashim Rathor, and then Shakibul Ghani. That pair put on 70 runs for this wicket, and Shakibul Ghani was one of the, you know, big movers in this game, because he got a 50 of his 43 balls, but thereafter he really took the attack to the opposition. And at one point of time when the score was looking at 120 or 130, it's gone to 163 now, and that looks like a fairly average, but not a very challenging, but still. Good work done there by the seamers. 29 from Gaurav, Rahul Kumar. Of course, Gaurav got that wicket of the first wicket. But the spinners were a little expensive, especially Sarfaraz Ashraf taking to the cleaners for 41 runs.
Absolutely. And it was Sarfaraz on whom he was really severe. Really severe, Shakibul Ghani. And a result of that was playing a blistering knock of 80-odd. And... well, the byproduct of that is that Angika Avengers now need 163 runs to win this very first match of the Bihar Cricket League. At this point in time, Ravi, I would reckon that the happier team right now would certainly be Patna Pilots.
Well, definitely Patna Pilots would be happy, because they've got the runs on the board. And can they make them count? That is going to be the key, as the two openers already out. Raju Kumar... there on your screen, batting for Angika Avengers. Now, if we can make the power play count, that could be really tough.
And I reckon they were looking initially, when they put in the opposition to bat, they were probably looking at a total around 140, maybe 145, maybe 150. But this one... and particularly the way Shakibul Ghani just exploded towards the end of the innings, took the total to a little above par, a little above what Angika would have earlier anticipated when they put Patna into bat. So it's 163 to win. Opening the bowling attack would be Rashmikant Ranjan for the Patna Pilots. The run rate, the required run rate, is just a shade above 8 runs and over. And well, in the T20 game, initially, if you don't get too many in the first few overs, particularly when you're chasing in upwards of 8 runs per over, then in no time, it just skyrockets. And very soon, you're chasing 9 and 10 runs and over. So it's imperative that Angika Avengers make full use of the first 6 overs.
Well, the first 6 overs had cost them 31, I think, Angika Avengers, and they'd like to go plenty more than that and not lose any wickets. That's the battle plan. But then, best laid plans can go awry, as it is Rashmikant Ranjan getting us underway, Patna Pilots.
First ball down the leg side, down the leg side, that's called a wide. And well, contrasting starts to both the innings. The first innings we saw, it was a wicket of the first ball. And this one, spraying down the leg side. And the keeper does really well to actually latch onto it. It's one run on the board for Angika Avengers.
Scoring opens with a wide, left-handed Nishant. Again down the leg side, so that's two on the trot wides. Remember, Angika Avengers just gave away 4 extras, only one of them wide.
Again, I think he just needs to reload again that one. Misaligned for the first 2 deliveries, Rashmikant. And you don't need to do anything when you get freebies over there. You just very calmly collect it. It's like a sale happening right now. And the consumer of that happens to be Angika Avengers. And they're making the most of it. Right now, the onus is on the bowler again to get this on the right line.
Time clipped away towards the deep fine leg area. First runs off the bat, but Angika Avengers wouldn't mind this kind of a start because the bowler is struggling to get his line right. Now, Raju Kumar wearing shirt number 17 for the Angika Avengers. Angika is the language spoken in the Bhagalpur region, Bhagalpur, Kalgaon. That area in the eastern part of Bihar, bordering Bengal and Jharkhand. So you got a pretty strong influence of the Bangla culture in that part of the state.
That's flashed hard. Oh, and that, oh my God, did that carry or didn't it? Well, the bowler just... and. Even Danny Morrison just a little disgruntled with that one. But we need to see over there if that ball carried to the third man. Oh, it didn't. It didn't. And he did well over there. Got his body well behind it. And in the bargain, stopped the boundary.
Definitely put his body on the line. He knew he could never reach that. The ball was traveling really quick. But Raju opens his account as well as Angika Avengers move on to 4 without loss. Just 2 legal deliveries bowled so far. Again down the leg side. So having trouble keeping the line right to the left-hander. And Nishant, well, he wouldn't be minding him extra time on the wicket.
And that's a little bizarre from the bowler over there, the way he's just kind of, you know, spraying the delivery down the leg side. He's got predominantly an offside field with one man behind square and there's another one who is in the mid-wicket region. So there should be no reason why he should be bowling it down the leg side.
Well, trying to keep the ball close to the stumps on the off and middle line, probably one of the... better tactics would be to go over this. All bowlers are not comfortable bowling round the wicket because he's having forced to come to keep the line close. Again, down the leg side, this time swung back. Fine leg will pick it up, but runs are coming without too many problems. Just 3 legal deliveries bowled, score already 5.
And you know, these are just contrasting visuals if we compare it to the first innings when...
Patna Pilots were batting. Gaurav, along with Gaurav, Rahul bowled really tight lines. They asked questions. And apart from that, they bowled deliveries in the corridor of uncertainty. But over here, the batsmen are just finding it too easy. Again down the leg side, but hits the pads. And the batsmen have enough time to come for a single.
Well, not the best of overs to open their defense for Patna Pilots. But then they've come back from a worse thing in the batting. So why can't they come back here? It's definitely what the captain would be saying, Mangal Mehroor. Mangal Mehroor, the captain, is wearing shirt number 177. The only man with the three-digit number on his back.
Again down the leg side. So it's total misalignment for the bowler until now. There have been three wides until now. And that one again sprayed down the leg side. And without having to do much of hard work, there are already 8 runs on the board with a ball to spare in the first over of the Angika innings.
One more legal delivery to go. Why I insist on legal is because three wides have already come in this over. 8 without loss, chasing 163. 163 the target. Much better line to end the first over. One over gone, 8 without loss.
So, Angika Avengers are replying Patna Pilots right now. Patna Pilots posting, well, if not a daunting, then you can rather say a pretty respectable total on the board of 162 runs for the loss of 3 wickets, courtesy a blistering knock from the blade of Shakib Ul Ghani, who scored 87 of just 60-odd balls. And right now, Angika Avengers, they have 8 runs on the board. And moving along nicely, but that's courtesy some wayward bowling by the Patna bowler.
Pawan Kumar, it will be to bowl the second over. Nishant batting on 3, Raju on 1. Pawan setting his field. Wants it exactly right. Right arm over to the left-hander. So I think he's preferred to go with his own line. Wearing shirt number 7. Pawan.
Oh, that's beautifully played over there. Just held it along the leg side. Played it behind square. And that's gone for a boundary. An effort in vain by the boundary rider over there. But 4 runs, and that's the first boundary from the blade of the Angika batsman.
First boundary, and it was actually an invitation from the batsman, from the bowler, beg your pardon. And good chase there, but Nishant will not mind that. Picks up a boundary of the first ball of the over. So that takes the pressure off the batsman. Can afford to play a couple of deliveries like that. The target isn't too high. 163 is what the target for Angika Avengers. So Patna Pilots need to make things happen. And to make things happen, they need to pick up wickets. At the moment, the bowlers have not really posed too many tough questions to the Angika batsmen. The openers enjoying their stay in the middle so far.
Again down the leg side, probably just flicking the pad over there. We'll wait for the umpire signal. And yes, that is a leg bias. So this has been wayward bowling from Patna Pilots until now. They really need to rein it in, because without having to do much of hard work, Angika Avengers already have 13 on the board. Danny Morrison wouldn't be too happy, who's the mentor of Patna Pilots. For Angika Avengers, their mentor happens to be Venkatesh Prasad. And Ravi, that's a fantastic thing. All these stalwarts, the likes of Sanat Jayasurya, Tilak Ratni Dilshad, R.P. Singh, getting attached to all these sides.
Well, Venkatesh Prasad not around for Angika Avengers, so his duties have been taken over by Subroto Banerjee, whom we saw a short while ago in the Angika Avengers dugout. There you see the captain wearing the unique number 177. Mangal Mahroor just scored 2 runs there while he was batting, but now needs to lead his team's challenge. Spawan. It's time straight down the ground and really deposits it outside. So what a hit there from Raju Kumar.
Well, lucky 7 as they call it, 7-7-7 galore. So that those sevens were just kind of broken by a 6 over there. And with that, Raju moves on to the score of 13. Beg your pardon, 7. And that's cut away. The ball was bowled into him, but doesn't go beyond the 30-yard circle.
You're talking about the sevens. Raju's batting on 7, so is Nishant. Bowler's wearing shirt number 7. 2 overs gone. 19 without loss.
Right, folks, so this is Bihar Cricket League, and that is Danny Morrison, who's the mentor of the Patna Pilots. This is the chance for Bihar to showcase its talent. The likes of Tamil Nadu, the likes of Karnataka, the likes of Saurashtra, they've already jumped onto the T20 wagon. And courtesy that, they've given some fine products, some fine players to the IPL and also to Team India. This is Bihar's chance to bask in the T20 glory.
Enjoying a hot cup of tea there, despite the hot weather. Danny Morrison from New Zealand. As we see some spin being employed early, that's Shashim Rathore, shot number 27.
And Shashim is quite a handy off-spinner as well. We saw him earlier in the day when he bolstered the innings for his home side, Patna Pilots. Has played a fair amount of matches. In the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy also, he was one of the openers, along with Mangal Mehroor, who is the captain of the Patna Pilots. What remains to be seen is, can he work his magic? Can he get the first wicket for his team over here?
Well, scored 38 of 36, Shashim Rathore. For he was well caught by Ashraf. Now, can he turn that magic around with the ball? That is going to be the big question for Patna Pilots. Already those 5 extras will be hurting. They're only in over number 3.
Play towards the mid-wicket region. The good old Hoik. And that's gone for 4 runs. no issues there whatsoever, and he is livid. Shashim Rathor is livid. But what needs to be asked is that why is he livid? Because that was quite an ordinary delivery, which got the treatment which it deserved.
Well, possibly expected a better effort from the long on fielder, who did give chase but gave up early. And that's why, I mean, not only do you score runs, but you also want to defend. This time the long on fielder is alert. Just that single. Score moves on to 24 without loss. We are in the third over.
It's a big day for Bihar cricket. Obviously, reinstated back in 2018 for a good part of 15 years. Didn't play Ranji Trophy. Didn't play any cricket which was accredited by the BCCI. It was the sister state of Jharkhand who gained prominence. But now it's Bihar's time.
And let's not forget that suspension happened before the division of Bihar and Jharkhand. So it was still the unified Bihar which got suspended. The suspension stayed with Bihar. Jharkhand got the recognition courtesy of Amitabh Chaudhary's hard work in that state. Got a lovely stadium as well in the Jharkhand capital of Ranchi. Pushed away for a single. That brings us to the end of over number three. Three overs gone, 27 without loss, Angika Avengers.
Right, so we welcome you back from the Urja Stadium here in Patna. Match number one of the Bihar Cricket League happening between the Angika Avengers and the home team, Patna Pilots. 163 is the target. And right now, the batting team going along nicely. That's played really well. Really well for four runs over there. And well, easy pickings for the batsman, Ravi.
Plenty of room outside the off stump, and when the batsmen have spent so much time in the middle, obviously they've got a feel of the wicket, and this is invitation to disaster. Just allowing the batsmen to free their arms and bisect that fielder at cover point and point. No chance for either of them. Raju Kumar now moves on to 17 of just 11. Nishant happy to bide his time.
Tight lines is what they require. But what's happening right now is either the bowler is just spraying the ball down the leg side, or he's giving the batsman too much room. They don't want to spoil the hard work the batsman put in towards the fag end of the innings, particularly Shakib Ul Ghani, who played a blistering knock of 87 runs today.
Once again, room outside the off stump, and this will go all the way. Nice, juicy ball, wide outside the off stump. Good height from the short delivery. No need for a second invitation. There you see, cut and cut fiercely, maximum yield.
What a shot, what a shot. Every time you see this uppercut, visuals of Virender Sehwag flash in your head, and such a shot that makes your heart throb, and that was just flashed beautifully over the third man area for six runs. And right now, Angika Avengers curtsy that six, move on to 37. The current run rate moving well beyond 10 runs per over, which is doing no harm to their initial required run rate of just a shade over 8 runs and over.
Again, straight. And another 6. No problems whatsoever. Raju seems to be having a plane to catch from the nearby airport.
really targeting Pawan Kumar. His first over had gone for 11. This time he's already gone for 16 in the first four deliveries. Very, very well hit there from Raju Kumar.
These are contrasting fortunes for the two teams. We remember in the power play how Patna Pilots were. They were sedate. They were a little held back. And that's gone for a four. Well played again, the bowler. Just straying it down the leg side, using the pace and dispatched it towards the boundary for four more runs.
If Raju Kumar keeps batting like this, those drummers will be tired out pretty soon. Got 20 of this over so far. Still got delivery to come, and very so well placed there. He knew the moment he hit it, it was racing to the boundary. 47 without loss. Oh, inside edge, no damage done. Four overs done, 47 without loss.
Well, this chase is going to the stratosphere right now. 47 on the board. Only four overs have elapsed. And, well, Angika Avengers, at this rate, we might be in for early tea, Ravi.
Well, definitely. And those sixes that are hitting may put those low-flying aircraft in danger, because the airport is not very far from here. Depends on the traffic. It could take you 4 minutes or 45. But at the moment, Angika Avengers are absolutely in cruise control. 24 legal deliveries is what they've faced. Just need 116 more. The batsmen are cruising. The last over cost them 20 runs. So Pilots under all kinds of pressure. Rashmikant Ranjan back. Nishant Kumar now joins the party. Starts off with a boundary.
This is belligerent. This is really belligerent stuff from the batsmen over here. Every time they get an inch, they just take a yard out of it and dispatch it to the boundary. That's the hallmark. That's been the hallmark of the innings until now. Every time a bad delivery is bowled, they've taken no prisoners over there and they've dispatched it to the boundary. Brilliant batting by Angika.
Quick comparison. 50 has come up in four overs and one delivery for Angika Avengers. For Patna Pilots, it came off, 50 had come off 9.2. So nine overs and two deliveries is what Patna Pilots had needed. Oh, this time a swing and a miss from Nishant. But the left-hander has been a spectator most of the time in the last two overs, where Raju has been making merry. Possibly he told Raju that now it is my turn to go after them. Very close to that off stump, but wasn't very sure where to play it. Was in two minds.
Again, this time around, it was there's some misunderstanding in the middle, but enough time for the non-striker to get back to his crease. But again, you see, the intent is there. There has been a boundary in this over, but again, he tried to hoik that one towards the offside region. Obviously, not able to connect. Some misunderstanding in the middle, but had ample time to get back to the crease. So it's the intent. And it's because of the intent that Angika Avengers right now have crossed 50. Just below 50. Five overs, and that one again flayed outside the off stump, gone for another boundary, one bounce into the fence.
Well, the attacking intent is really, really taking its toll on the Patna Pilots bowlers. Not able to keep a tidy line, one bounce into the fence. So Nishant Kumar comes to the party with back-to-back boundaries of three deliveries that he is
faced in this over. Pressure on Patna Pilots totally. Rashmi Ranjan had given away 7 in his first over. Gone for 8 so far. And will go for more. Another boundary. That's the third boundary of the over. One more delivery to come.
I believe after this match, the Patna Pilots would get a rap on the knuckles from Danny Morrison. Again, too full, too wide, and that's easy pickings. These batsmen are far too good to just let that opportunity go. And if you were to kind of probably make a bouquet or a pitch map of where the Patna bowlers have bowled today, it's been really off. Either it's been outside the off stump where the batsmen have gone behind and flayed it outside the off stump, or they've sprayed it down the leg side and they've just used the pace and dispatched it towards the boundary. That was bowled nicely. End of the over. 5 gone. It's 59 for no loss. Right, welcome back to the Urja Stadium here in Patna, and this is the reply of Angika Avengers. They've been going hammer and tongs against right now, which seems like a listless bowling attack from Patna. Patna putting up, quite a decent score on board, courtesy a blistering knock from Shakib Ul Ghani. 162 on the board, but right now, back in the commentary box, Padamjeet, Sehrawat, they are making light work of it, Padam, until now.
Absolutely. I mean, they did 2 things right. One, they won the toss. They put the opponents in, got the wicket of the first ball. So, Bihar Cricket League got off to the best start you could imagine, because it's always called a batsman's game. So, here we said, wicket of the first ball. Then, there were 2 solid partnerships. But, they're batting at the moment. The way Nishant and Raju are playing, when I say Nishant, I get reminded of Nishant Dayal. Whose baby it is, whose product it is. We'll be meeting him soon in the post-match presentation after this first game. But so far, they're in the driver's seat. 34 for Raju, 21 for him. But surprise element is the name of the game.
Indeed. That's the narrative of the T20 game, Padam. But right now, I think the Patna team management, the coach Danny Morrison, would be just really disgruntled about the fact that, yes, Angika Avengers, they batted well, but it's the bowlers who haven't created too many opportunities. Flaying down the leg side, then probably over-pitching, but the batsmen have converted it.
Talk about conversion. This is the last over of the power play, so they'll have to first make sure that they just don't let the batsman off the hook much. And constantly, see, when you have a left-hander and a right-hander, everyone in the field is busy. You can see changes are being made, extra cover being brought in. Now, where are the 2 men patrolling the boundary line? I'll just fetch them. One is deep mid-wicket, the other one is long on. There he goes, 4. Right 4. No one protecting the boundary there. This is poor bowling and this is good batting.
Yes, that was really well done. And again, the belligerent approach of the batsman continues. Slightly using the depth of the crease over there. Going on the back foot, rocking back and pulling it away behind square for yet another boundary.
And that has been the story so far. Bat over ball yet again. You must learn from your mistakes, otherwise the boundary will be followed by a 6. Danny Morrison saying, no problem, I'll make merry at the end of the day. It's all about the smiles, it's all about the joys. Boy, oh boy, another 6.
Well, to be honest, that's pedestrian stuff from the bowler right now. The previous delivery was also bowled in the same direction, but this was even worse, and that was helped easily by the batsman for yet another 6. In comes Khalid. This time a little short, not short enough, but reaches just the man in the cover region.
The Patna Pilots, when they were batting, after the power play, they were 31 for 2. Oh, they kept low and they fetch a wicket. They get a wicket on the last ball of the power play. That one kept low, but there was an over-ambitious shot too. Is that the change in the slide that we're watching? There it is. Short? Yes, it was. But it did not bounce as much as he anticipated it. Poor anticipation, surface aiding. A bowler cannot bowl that ball. I mean, you can't bowl that one to keep low. There's no art to that. The surface takes it down, creeps it low. Nishant, 22 from 15, wicket falling, 71 for 1.
Right, so just at the end of the power play, there's good news. Good news there for the bowling team. Just when Angika Avengers were running away with it, there's a wicket of the last ball of the power play. And now in comes Mehroor, the captain. Can he spin a web? Can he spin a web around the batsman? And there you go. That's the first six overs for you. Belligerent batting at its very best.
Yeah, in the right hand and the left hand combination, outside off slash, that was the shot of the day for me, that six over point. And then the left hander too was always in the game. They were complementing each other so very well. Anything bowled within the stumps, field was up. And then while trying to replicate the same shot, he perished. Live by the sword, die by it too. Do you think there's this more twists and turn coming in this one, Sid?
Well, I reckon it's going to be a straightforward one unless until somebody in the bowling side comes up with a sterling performance. Because if you look at the current required run rate, Padam, there's nothing much. If they just kind of milk the bowling, take the easy singles, just play to the field, I think this is a straightforward chase for them.
I thought you had the makings of a writer who would write thrillers in you. Mangal comes into bowl. Ashwani Kumar is the new batsman for them. Is there contest in this one? I mean, see, we've seen stranger things happening in the game. So, the last thing I would want to see from the Patna Pilots is the shoulders drooping, the body language being different. Trust in the process. Believe in your ability. If you... It's all about phases. They enjoyed the phase of 5.5 overs. You got a wicket of the last ball of the power play. Things can change. Believe in yourself.
You need belief. But right now, I think Patna needs a whole lot of urja. And urja can only come in the form if you pick quick wickets. They've got one when things were looking really downhill for them. But now, Mangal, can he just do something on which we can say that Patna ke liye sab Mangal mein hai?
Yeah, there are two ways to look at it. One, you can say that produce the urja first, then get wickets. The other way to look at it is let wickets come and then we'll show the energy. I think the first one would be more appropriate because show the energy to pick up wickets. Because when you pick up wickets, the body language will automatically be better. You'll be yelling, you'll be shouting, you'll be celebrating. This is the time. Talk to yourself. Bring that chirp on. They are very quiet on the field for my liking.
Urja, wickets. Wickets, urja. What came first, the hen or the egg?
They would be hoping any which way they want a wicket. Oh, he's timing it to perfection. He knows where the gaps are. That is just 2 feet short of a six. So, another boundary. Dominating this player. Nishant getting on to 28 with that good-looking boundary. It was short. He read it. Outside off. Picks it. Mid-wicket. Four. Easy. He makes it look easy.
He makes it look easy. But apart from that, the bowling, again, lot to be desired. End of the over. Seven gone. 79 for one.
Ashwani 2, Nishant 28, looking solid. And this is good from the captain that because a right-hander perished, you've sent a right-hander. You should try and make that combination to be left-hand, right-hand as much as you can, because not only does it threaten the bowling, it puts doubts in the minds of the opponents. Well bowled turn. Good turn. I like the loop as well. There's something to watch in this leg spinner. Watch out for Summer. First ball, deadly. Very accurate.
We got two clairvoyants in the comm box. Earlier it was Ravi. Now it's Padam. So we'll watch out for his prediction as well. Meanwhile, that's been played nicely towards the long off region for yet another single.
I can never be as good as Ravi Kant Singh in predictions. I'm poor. All I'm good at is admiring when somebody gets his prediction right. I'm very good at it. That's the field for you. Fine leg. Oh, you were third man inside the circle point. Sweeper is more towards point than cover. When you look at the sweeper bound down at the boundary line. Short, pulls it, man stationed right there.
So half of the runs have been achieved until now by the Avengers. And when it comes to overs, we are still not halfway there. Just in the eighth over right now, this has been a fantastic start by the Angika Avengers, contrasting to the kind of start the Patna Pilots had. If there was a worm right now, I would have shown you how the worm just slowly moved initially. And then there was that major spike towards the end, courtesy Shakib Ul Ghani. The leg spinner into action. Plays nicely towards the boundary rider over there and comes for a single.
So far, so good. Chasing the total that they've got to chase, and they are not looking perturbed at all. The wicket fell, but Nishant that one and is making sure that he's still playing in the fashion that he loves playing, attacking cricket. The over has been quiet though, three runs from the four balls that Summer has bowled. I see a lot of potential in Summer. I like bowlers who toss it up. I like bowlers who have a high arm action. There he goes, well done. Googly reads it from the arm.
I guess nothing can beat the marvel, nothing can beat the entire thrill and the skill of seeing a wrist spinner bowling. And that is what Summer is doing. Getting all his experience into play and tossing it nicely. This one played towards behind square. It's the end of the over. Eight gone. It's 82 for one.
Anjika Avengers need 80 runs from 72 balls. Not that they look perturbed, disturbed at all, no. But all that we're hoping is for some divine intervention to bring some contest in this match. Sid?
Well, at this point in time, they look like two parallel lines. The two worms.
just how they went about the proceedings, the Patna Pilots, compared to that Angika Avengers, just leapfrogging right now. Oh, that was too close for comfort. Tried to be cute over there.
And got the introduction of right arm off spinner, because that's a leg spin for the left-hander. And you need to disturb the concentration of Nishant. You need to make him do something out of the obvious. Don't make things easy for him. Let him manufacture a shot. He's that kind of a player. If you dry out his runs, he'll then try to be adventurous. The moment any batsman tries to be adventurous, that's the time when you increase that risk element for yourself. And that gives you a chance to get him out. So dry those runs out.
It's the approach of the Angika batsman which has been so heartwarming. It's been so impressive. They knew about the first six overs. They went hard after the bowlers, made the most of it. And all the shots they've hit until now, Padam, they've been calculated risks. It's not that they tried the agricultural shot, the good old hoik. Yes, that's been there in the middle. But predominantly, it's been bad bowling of which they've made full use.
Reads it very well yet again. That was a googly. Read it from the arm. On drives it. Three runs from the over so far. Four legal deliveries. One was a wide. And they're cruising along. No problem whatsoever. Right from the time that they won the toss, they've done most things right except those two partnerships that came from Patna Pilots. Oh, is that a wicket? Is that a wicket? There is a chance. Yes, it is. The wicket that they badly wanted. The wicket that they deserve. They've got it. And it is the danger man, Nishant, walking back to the hut.
As they say, just what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered. And that is a big wicket against the run of play. Going for another hoik over the mid-wicket region. Getting a leading edge. And that was pouched rather easily by the hero of the first inning, Shakib Ul Ghani.
Well done. And this is what we were mentioning, you and I, that the introduction of that off spinner might just do the trick, dust the trick. Very, very happy bowler. It's a danger man walking back to the hut. He scored 31. Well played. Well, this is it. Back live. Nine overs completed, 87 for two.
Samar Kadri into the attack again, and a timely wicket in the previous over by Shashim Rathore. Crafty off spinner he is, and he exhibited that rather nicely in the previous over. 87 for 2 right now, Angika Avengers.
And good all round in the making. If you remember, he contributed very well with the bat as well. So this is how he got that wicket. And that was a poor shot in my opinion. I mean, by no stretch of imagination could you have got that from the middle of your bat and hoiked it over long on. So much bowled outside off stump, still going away from you. Well kept. normally wicket keepers don't get their due. Normally coaches always tell you to move like a pendulum. The wicket keepers that dive the least are the best, because they make up with their movements. They move so well that they don't need to dive. Those are the field placements for you. Slip in position. Good to see that. Well done. These two spinners, what they've done is, I'm not saying they're going to win this, but they have a faint chance now, because two new batsmen in the crease tighten the screws at this moment, make life difficult for them, make them work hard for their singles.
Captain Danny Morrison, the coach rather, he would be saying one more wicket, and you would have the cat amongst the pigeons. Well, surely, you can't say that the tide has changed. Right now, the required run rate is just a shade above 6 runs and over. So even right now, they can just milk the bowling and they can easily make this. But if one more wicket falls, then there might be some pandemonium out there in the middle for the batting side.
And the required run rate also isn't bothering them. 6.86. With dots such as that, with turns such as that, that required run rate will climb for sure. No doubt about that. Beautifully bowled. Watch that replay. All the youngsters watching, you'll know what I'm talking about. Beautiful action. Tosses it up. We'll come back to that later. Back live. Oh, takes the first one initially very hesitantly. Then his partner said, okay, two. And then they realized it was not there.
It's just the time when Patna Pilots need to show more energy. They know if they get one more wicket, they might just get inside the batting team right now. Runs for a quick single and makes it rather easily. End of the over, 10 gone. It's 93 for 2.
93 for 2. Two new batsmen of the crease. We're coming live from Urja Cricket Stadium in Patna. These are Patna Pilots trying to defend that score of 162 for 3 what they managed. Change in commentary box. Siddharth has made way for Ravi Kant Singh. Good evening, Ravi.
Good evening. And Khalid Alam back. He had the first wicket to fall, that of the Raju Kumar. So can he continue wielding that, weaving that same kind of magic? Khalid Alam again trying to keep things quiet. Easier said than done when you've set the target so low as 163. And the kind of start that Raju Kumar gave them, 44 of 21. Now that is the kind of start that you'd be looking at if you're chasing something 200, in the vicinity of 200, not 160.
True, but still they should tell themselves two good overs, maybe one wicket. That required run rate certainly climbs to 8 over. So the beauty about this game is that it has so many twists and turns. All that they now need to do is, Ashwani and Keshav, play with a good mindset, steady head. Don't try and manufacture shots, play on merit.
Last wicket, that of Nishant Kumar, 26 balls faced, 31 runs scored Nishant Kumar before he was removed by Rathore. And this time, ooh, where it goes, just over the ropes, cruel.
And I will not mince my words here, that's a drop catch, and to add injury to salt to injury, I beg your pardon, he misses it, and then that sails over him. Good effort, agreed, still a drop catch.
Badly misjudged. Padam, you're being too kind. He was at least 2 meters inside the boundary. Didn't need to jump. Had he stayed back, possibly would have held it easy. This time, fine leg is absolutely no chance. Got to chase and pick up ball from outside. So the 100 has also come up.
And that was cheeky. Picks it up from middle stump. He says, okay, let me have a little bit of fun. Just taps it. And they want to win big because there might be a situation, Ravi, where they might be in competition for a place in the semifinals. And the run rate might help them. So winning big helps because you have five teams. Each team plays four matches in the league stage. We'll come back and talk about it. 11 overs gone, 105 for 2.
Angika Avengers, 105 for 2, chasing 163 against Patna Pilots. And as Padam was just mentioning, the format is pretty unique. Clipped away for another easy single. Five-team league, and then four go into the knockout phase. So one team will lose out. So there will be lot of excitement, and this is a good idea by Avengers to win big, because one will play four, two will play three. So if you are a good net run rate, you can actually pick your opponents.
Dives well. Yeah, you're right. So try to win big. At the same time, Patna Pilots' think tank would say, okay, hold on. Even if we don't win this, let them reach down to that victory target in the 19th or 20th over. Not that they get points out of this, but they actually maintain a better run rate.
Well, definitely that would be what they would be aiming at. But a couple of wickets here, and suddenly the things could get rough. What Patna needs at the moment is wickets. At least two to really make the Avengers hit the panic buttons. But that kind of fielding won't help. Went past the hands. Pretty ordinary effort from the fielder.
You can't have a $1 million dream with a minimum wage work ethic. I mean, it's easy to aspire for great things, but where's the effort? With that kind of an effort, sorry lad, we're not being harsh, we are being factful.
Samar Kadri, the bowler, in his third over.
Beauty. Nearly took me down memory lane. Shane Warne to Mike Gadding.
Don't see too many of those in the 20 over version, mostly in the red ball cricket. Samar Kadri asking a few questions, but needs to be much, much more consistent.
That clearly would have been a better over without that poor delivery. Oh, that's good fielding. Make effort. 12 overs gone. This is 114 for 2. 27 to Ashwini, Keshav 5 of 6. Ravi bhai, I've never seen you too fond of taking selfies. Why is that?
I don't like my face. That's why
you can like your partner's face. Your partner's there with you. Co-commentator's there. Your friends are there. Bhabiji's there.
So I let them take the face, do all the hard work. Why bother?
Oh, that's a good one coming in. I really like the way you play these bouncers off and on.
Well, the grey hairs teach you a lot.
Knowledge is knowing that tomato is a fruit. Wisdom is not putting it in the fruit basket. Wisdom, sir.
Two runs there. Ooh, it seems like an appeal for a run out. And the umpires aren't sure. They will want to go upstairs, yes.
Well, if you look at the celebration from the bowler, it is evident. But these players can be fine actors as well.
Tell me about it. We've seen teams celebrating when the batsman has gone past the stumps. And, we'll have to wait for the TV umpire to decide whether Keshav Kumar...
Can I take a prediction? I think he's out. That's my natural instinct. And there it comes. If you are good, I'm not bad too.
Well, that is a good one because the dive goes in vain from the non-striker. That's Ashwini Kumar.
The other thing is, does the hand go through the stumps or does the wrist and the ball pass first and then is it the other part after the wrist that touches? It can be a very good point. If you miss it and if the remaining part after the wrist touches, then you are not out.
The ball, the hand holding the ball, the wrist, the entire hand counts up to the wrist. So anything there, the third umpire will have to decide, the TV umpire, whether he hit the ball or yes, he has given it out.
Yeah, the umpire says the verdict is coming that it was the ball and the wrist that touched the stumps and dismantled the bails. BCL Pride, an initiative of BCN Elite Sports. Partnership broken. 28 from 20 balls. Will that have a huge impact on the outcome of this one? And they will reveal it from here. And sometimes there can be a roadblock when you go on the road. It's up to you how you take it. You take it as an obstacle to be fought or as an opportunity to be enjoyed. It gave us more time to talk.
Well, definitely. It is not disastrous, but certainly something to celebrate for the Patna Pilots. So Ashwini Kumar, it has gone. 115 for 3 now. They're an over number 13. And an absolute cruise control for Angika Avengers, who won the toss and decided to field first. So Ashwini Kumar run out for 27, 115 for 3.
Down the leg side, normally there's an area where you can't bowl, so the umpires are very strict on that one. White signaled. But they're trying to do things now. Now they're not letting things happen. They're trying to find a way to manufacture a wicket.
Well, the batsmen aren't going to hang around. New batsman is Mohammad Sarfaraz Ashraf, wearing shirt number 1. And he's got Keshav Kumar for company. Ashwini Kumar run out for 27. That's Keshav Kumar for you. Ashraf stands out with his golden helmet. But can Shashim Rathore pull things back as he steadied the ship with his bat?
More out of anxiousness and nothing else. I really like the helmets these days. They're very stylish. They are very well made. It has become the need of the hour. Think about the days of the old. The likes of Sunny Gavaskar, Viv Richards, they never wore helmets. Scored tons of runs against the best fast bowlers in the world on wickets that were never covered.
Well, that indeed is all stuff of folklore when you got the likes of Michael Holding and company. Another easy single. It's the singles that Patna Pilots need to choke. That's when they'll get it. 13 overs gone, 118 for 3.
Ashwani, last batsman to have perished. Sarfaraz now on 1, Keshav on 7. 13 overs gone, 118 for 3. Look at the run rate that they're getting, the pace that they're getting with. Outside off, cuts it well, sweeper into the picture. Little bit of fumble, but because they were leisurely taking the first run, there was no possibility of taking a second. I mean, the moment you start to run fast and quick, that's the time you put pressure on those patrolling the boundary. And that's the time when fumbles happen.
Well, at the moment, the pressure is not really required to be put on the fielders because they are in cruise control. Ashwini Kumar bowling as leg spinners and a wide called. So the bowlers have been pretty generous with their wides. Going by my count, that should be the sixth wide.
And I'll trust your count. Taps it, wanted a single. Into the 14th over, there's a slowness to proceedings, Ravi. This is the time, and I would want to see a slip, irrespective of who's batting at the moment. Have a slip, especially when the left-hander's batting and the right-arm off is bowling.
Well, definitely that's a good idea because you try and do something out of the ordinary. You need to make something happen. Otherwise, the batsmen are running away with the match. Left-handed Sarfaraz Ashraf now.
Anjika Avengers required 42 runs from 38 balls. Sometimes, if just imagine there's a quiet over. One run, two runs. So far, 3 runs in the over. They follow it up with another good over. Add one more to this one. 4 from the over. So, suddenly the situation can change. So, you can never relax. Never relax.
Well, cricket is, as I say, is a funny game. It can turn around the space of a few deliveries. So, you can never, never take it for granted.
Over the bowler's head, safest, but you need to be skillful. That he is. Willful, that he is. Boundary is what he gets. 14 overs gone, 126 for 3. Thank you.
Angika Avengers at the moment looking in cruise control. They've got six more overs to get those 36 runs. Six runs an over in a 20-over contest doesn't feel like much, and obviously the supporters already ready to get the celebrations going as Shashim Rathore starts his fourth over. 3 overs for 16, which Shashim has given away. Sarfraz, high and handsome, 6 runs. Doesn't really believe in hanging around, does Sarfraz Ashraf? The left-hander making use of that angle. Gets the right elevation and the distance.
And there is no better sight for a batsman when you tonk it around and you watch it sail. He does it and then you just watch it. Oh boy, so much joy. And then tap a single, take the first run fast. Well done.
That's really smart batting. Not getting carried away with the previous hit. Keep your head cool. Get that calculator running. As you said, every batsman knows what his score is.
Right-hander says, I'm going to compliment my partner. You went over extra. I'm going to go over mid-wicket.
Keshav Kumar, it is, had a brilliant catch to boot to get rid of the Patna Pilots captain and now showcases his talent with the bat, going over the mid-wicket fence. So really, 33 more required. Again, single follows and makes it 2. The fielders are not attacking the ball, the batsmen are attacking the runs.
Smiling faces, happy faces. But sometimes what a win does is, and we're not saying they've won as yet, but if they win, what a win does is, it shoves under the carpet your flaws too. So even when you win, sit down and analyze where you can get better. There were 2 partnerships that they let flourish. We'll come back and talk about it. 15 overs gone. 1-4, 1-4-3.
Patna Pilots this time, an appeal for stumping from the wicketkeeper, Sraman Nigrod. Good, smart work there off the bowling of Ashwin, but the foot was firmly planted inside as Ashraf this time drives, picks up a single to go to the non-striker's end, and so has Padam taken a break. Moves away from the microphone and time to welcome back Siddharth Mishra. As I say, all done bar the shouting.
Well, this is just too easy for them now, isn't it? And that's courtesy the kind of approach they've had in different phases, Ravi. Initially, the first 6 overs, the power play, they just made hay while the sun was shining. There were wickets, but then that never changed the approach from them. And there are times in a match when you're just... meanwhile, that one was well bowled. There are times in a particular match when you just kind of tend to take things easy. And that in turn bites you in the back. But over here, just when they thought that they might get behind the 8 ball, they again changed the approach, went for the runs, and now it's just a matter of time.
A lot of that credit would go to Raju Kumar, 44 of 21. Nishant Kumar wasn't hanging around either, 31 of 26. Enthusiastic supporters of Angika Avengers seem to have enjoyed plenty of support, even though they are 200 kilometers plus away from their area.
16 gone, 144 for 3.
Right, so I'm assuming these are the last rights of the inaugural game of the inaugural Bihar Cricket League. Just as you have a look at the partnerships over there, the first one just blew the opposition away. Well, that was operating at 2 runs a ball almost, 71 of 36, then 15 of 17. And then the two partnerships between Ashwini Kumar, Keshav Kumar, and then Sarfaraz joining Keshav Kumar. This one should just see the end of the day for the Angikai Ventures.
Well, that was definitely wide had he let it go, but Ashraf didn't want to miss out on the opportunity to pick up yet another boundary. Goes on to 16 now. Actually, the tone of the chase was set in the first over itself when Rashmikant Ranjan sent down those three wides at a 9-ball over. Didn't cost him too much, just 8. But that really set the tone for the Angika chase. And there you see the result. Another 6. Ashraf seems to have a plane to catch.
They're just making light work of it right now, Ravi. Nothing is going the way of the bowling team. That is Patna Pilots. As you mentioned, the tone was set by the bowlers. And that just reminds me of Steve Harmison bowling consecutive wides in a certain Ashes series, and that was the pretty much the end of it for England in that one. And that is bowled wide and stumped quite easily over there. We need to wait for the umpire signal if that was a wide or not. Might as well be, but that's a wicket at the end of the day for the Patna Pilots. So 4 down now with in touching distance of the first victory of the first Bihar Cricket League.
Well, Ashraf will definitely be kicking himself for having jumped out so far and signaled his intent so early. So Ashwini bowled it wide and Smaran Nigroth didn't make a mistake. Sarfaraz gone for 22. ...148 now for 4.
Well, you mentioned, Ravi, a short while back, the importance of... So just 9 more remaining, 9 more runs to get for the Angika Avengers and a whole lot of deliveries in hand. They are losing wickets at regular intervals, but again, the entire importance of the first 6 overs where they just took the attack to the cleaners and just changed the complexion of the game. After that, it was just a matter of if Patna bowlers can probably spring up a huge miracle, which hasn't quite happened, and courtesy of which Angikai Ventures right now in the box seat.
New batsman is Utkarsh Bhaskar, opens his account. Utkarsh will be pretty happy to get an opportunity to spend some time in the middle. We'll pick up another easy single, Utkarsh. 17 overs gone, 157 for 4. And if you're just wondering why the crowd is hanging around, they've got another game to go. That's Bhagalpur versus Darbhanga. Bhagalpur Bulls will take on the Darbhanga Diamonds on the same track as the Angika Avengers, now going through the formalities. Another single for Utkarsh. He moves on to run a ball three. Keshav Kumar can finish up with a six here.
That's another prophecy from you, Ravi. And, well, law of averages going against you over there.
I said can, not will. See, English is such a nice language. It allows you to wriggle out of tight situations.
You're a man of convenience, I see.
You got to learn as you live on. Very smartly done by Keshav. This is rubbing salt into the wounds. Taking quick singles, picking up runs. Danny Morrison will have plenty to say. Not that he ever lacks words.
That was well bowled by Summer. He's been impressive. He's been tossing the ball up. Quite a crafty leg spinner. He's been using some of his variations. But now, I think Angika Avengers, they need to be a little cautious. They should just kind of finish it off in quick time. Just one stroke away from victory right now. Because, as you mentioned earlier in one of her commentary stints, one plays four and three plays two. So, if at all there is a weak team per se, somebody who's finishing at the top would want to play them in the semi-finals.
They can see the smiling faces in the dugout. That was the team doctor sitting with Subrata Banerjee. And that should do it. Well, there's it will. So, Angika Avengers win by six wickets without too much ado. Cruising to victory. 165 for four, chasing 163 for victory, and that is really a good, solid performance. And that miss field tells you the entire story of the match.
Touche. I was just about to say that. In fact, I was just waiting for you to put down your mic so that I could mention that. But there's some telepathy happening over here, Ravi. I was just about to mention that sums up the day for the Patna Pilots. Everything they touched today, barring that sterling knock from Shakib Ul Ghani, just turned to dust. And on the other hand, Angika Avengers were a far superior side. And especially when it came to their batting. In the first six overs, they just wrestled the initiative and took the game away from the Patna Pilots. And in the process, they win the first match, the inaugural match of the inaugural Bihar Cricket League tournament. So celebration time here for Angika.
Well, definitely Angika can afford to celebrate long and hard, because it was not very easy to be fielding out there in this hot sun. But they stuck to the task. Patna Pilots asked to bat first, scored 162 for three, and Angika were up to the challenge, scoring 165 for four. To win the match by six wickets. So Angika, start with those full points. And I think as we were talking about the knockouts, and the best strategy is to win everything, finish at number one, let others worry about it. And this is how the reply panned out. Angika Avengers, Raju Kumar and Nishant had a 71 run partnership, 44 from Raju, and Nishant Kumar contributed 31. And that
partnership really laid the foundation of the strong reply. Ashwini Kumar unfortunately run out for 27, but Keshav Kumar wasn't hanging back. 24. Ashraf paid the penalty of being a little too adventurous. 22 before he was stumped by Sraman Nigroth. Khalid picking up two wickets. Utkarsh Bhaskar ran all his four runs before that hit to the boundary took Angika Avengers over the line. So they have won with 12 deliveries to spare, which in 20 overs is a good mile. But one must say that Angika Avengers went about their task with a plan, and that plan was executed to perfection. And that's where you see the match reply there. They've had things in control.
Well, there's one thing, Ravi, to have the intent, but they also, along with the intent, they had the ammunition. The first six overs, that was the wicket, kept low over there. But apart from that, the intent was always there. Aggression was the name of the game. Anything short was pulled away. Anything up to the batsman was hit over the boundary. That one not quite coming from the meat of the bat. But despite a flurry of wickets, the batsman kept going. A few misfields also there in the at the boundary. But despite that, they kept going, and it was pretty much the doing of the opening batsman that provided such a strong foundation. A run out towards the end of the game as well, but that never deterred the batsman from going for their shots. Nice meaty blows over the boundary. And towards the end, things were, well, far too easy for Angika Avengers. And there you go, that's the flag. Flying high, flying at the top, in pole position after game one of the inaugural Bihar Cricket League.
But certainly you would say Angika Avengers had the dream start, kept things under control when they were bowling, kept the opposition down in the power play itself, just allowed 31 runs and picked up two wickets as well. So that really served them very well. And that's how the bowlers panned out. Rashmikant Ranjan didn't have the best of days, two overs costing him 19 runs. And those wides in the opening over really had things pretty much out of control for Patna Pilots. Sashim Rathore, another good performance from him with the ball as well, following up with the bat. Khalid picked up two wickets for 37. Mangal bowled one over for 8. Samar Kadri was again effective but couldn't get the breakthroughs that his team needed. Ashwini Kumar, two overs for 11. Bowling performance, nothing really to write home about, except possibly Khalid Alam, who has picked up the two wickets and picked them up smartly. The first partnership, 71 run, that is what really did them in and set up the chase. 9 runs extras, out of which 6 were wides, so that shows how effective the batting was, and certainly not going on the back foot at all. Mangal Maror will have a lot to think about because his team has been at the receiving end. Khalid Alam, the pick of the bowlers, 3 overs, 37 runs for his 2 wickets, but they will need a far better batting performance than this to come back.
Well, if you were to equate it to a one-day win, then this is as good as winning it with 10 overs to spare. Because if 20 overs are like pretty much like one-fifth of an ODI game, then 2 overs are like 10 overs to spare. So this is a thumping win by the Angika Avengers. A lot to think for the Patna Pilots. And right now, one man who would be really gutted would be Shakib Ul Ghani, because towards the end, there was a time when Patna Pilots, they looked as if they would not get too many, but he got quite a few for them. Right now, we'll just throw over to the presentation ceremony where we have Padam Singh Sharawat.
In hibernation for 15 years, but past is done, buried history. Bihar cricket is looking at glory at the moment. Why do I say so? Because what an encounter. What a step taken for Bihar Cricket League. I'm Padamjit Sharawat and I welcome you to the presentation of the first day, first game on the doubleheader. And I welcome the presentation party right here. On to my left, Sanjeev Ratan Singh, Chairman BCL Governing Council. Nishant Dayal, very happy Nishant Dayal, Director Elite Sports Management. And then we have Amit Pandey, very proud owner of the winning team, Angika Avengers. Clearly, I would like to speak to the losing captain first. Mangal, aa jaiye. Kehte hain khel mein aap jab koshish karte hain to haarte nahi hain, ya to aap jeette hain ya aap seekhte hain. Aaj kya seekha?
Aaj humne seekha ki hame kuch aur ڈالنا ہوگا
اگلے میچ میں اگر آپ ٹاس جیت گئے تو کیا کریں گے
گیند بازی کروں گا
اور آج اپنی ٹیم کو کیا کہیں گے کیونکہ جب ٹیم ہار جاتی ہے تو مورال کئی بار نیچے آ جاتا ہے کیا کہیں گے کہ ہنسی ہے زندگی میں ہنسنا بہت ضروری ہے
ہاں وہ تو بہت ضروری نہ ہو
ڈینی موریسن کا آپ سب کے اراؤنڈ ہونا کتنا بڑا امپیکٹ ہے وہ کیا کہتے ہیں آپ سب کو
تھینک یو سر
Clearly, we would like to speak to the winning captain at this moment, and the winning captain is a very proud captain. Ashutosh, please come. आपने पहला कदम ही बड़ा अच्छा रख दिया था जब टॉस जीता था तभी से लग गया था मुकाबला भी जीतेंगे
नहीं ऐसा तो नहीं कह सकते तीन मीडियम पेसर से हम खेल रहे थे तो उस हिसाब से अच्छा एग्जीक्यूट किया बॉलर्स ने और इस ग्राउंड का साइज और कंडीशंस देख के 160 पे अगर किसी भी टीम को हम रोकते हैं तो वो एक अच्छा बॉलिंग एफर्ट है
कई दफ़ा जब आप जीत भी जाते हैं तब भी कुछ चीज़ें कारपेट के अंदर छुप जाती हैं वो कौन सी चीज़ें हैं जिन पर आप और गौर करना चाहेंगे बेहतर होना चाहेंगे
जी बिल्कुल स्लॉग ओवर्स में हमने लास्ट के चार ओवर में 50 के करीब रन दे दिए वो एक कंसर्न था और नेक्स्ट मैच में कोशिश करेंगे कि उस पर काम करें
वेल डन ऑल द बेस्ट
थैंक यू वेरी मच
क्लियरली व्हाट दैट डज इज इट ऑफ द फर्स्ट बिहार क्रिकेट लीग गोज टू राजू फॉर हिज वेरी क्विक फायर इनिंग्स And he comes here with a huge round of applause. वो कहते हैं कि और ये it will be given to him by Amit. Avengers, first man of the match of the first game on day one of Bihar Cricket League. This is going to be memorable. ये आपसे कोई नहीं छीन सकता राजू आप हमेशा पहले man of the match winner के हकदार कहलाए जाएंगे मैं सोच रहा था अब तक आप आए जहाँ हंसे नहीं थे अब ट्रॉफी लेके आप हंसे हैं इस मुस्कुराहट के और क्या क्या कारण
जीत सबसे बड़ी कारण होती है किसी भी मुस्कुराहट की और वो हमारी टीम ने आज अचीव किया
और टीम के बारे में क्या लगती है हमें लगा कि यूनिट इट्स नॉट अबाउट
लोग बहुत एक साथ रहते हैं और एक साथ खेल रहे लगा दूसरे के परफॉर्मेंस को भी एंजॉय करते हैं वो टीम अच्छी होती है और वो हमारे टीम में है जीत पाऊं या ना बड़ी वाली ट्रॉफी जीतने की इच्छा है हमारी
क्या बात है Well, the message from the center is that all these players are putting the team ahead of their own effort. This is Padamjit Sharawat sending it back to the commentators.
Well, Raju Kumar, deserving man of the match winner. 44 of 21 balls and this is how the inaugural contest of the Bihar Cricket League 2021 panned out. Angika Avengers won the toss. And asked Patna Pilots to bat was set a target of 163, which Angika Avengers chased down with two overs to spare. Raju Kumar, their leading scorer, 44 of 21 deliveries. So he walks off with a deserving winner of the Man of the Match.